Welcome along to H&A Oval in Broadbeach for this round 9 battle between the Cats and the Thunder. Matt Ridley here, joined with Jess Webster. Beautiful conditions greet the players today, and not a breath of wind to speak of. Jess, I'm going to tip the Cats, but I think this will be a close one.
Oh, absolutely. Look, it's going to be a very tough ask for Thunder to get away with a win here. Interestingly, Broadbeach have won the last 3 encounters between the two sides, but the last time Thunder played here, Darren Ewing kicked 9 goals and Thunder won by 64 points. So are we going to see the same again?
The Thunder to the right, and they'll go forward through Philip Wills towards full forward. It'll bounce. Wolf Ewing in that familiar spot. The Cats under pressure early, but they'll work it out. Eventually a tumbling kick towards Nathan Quick for the Cats, but the ball doesn't bounce kindly. The handball from Argus puts Rioli under some pressure, back to Argus and now to Smith. And they link up through hand and create some space here on centre wing. A bounce here from Argus to Rioli. From about 75, he squares it up to an interesting spot here. This is Nathan Brown. Cannot quite pick it up. Stewart's there. Under some pressure early here, the Cats with no clean possession. Walton, the umpire will say he'll come in and bounce it down deep in attack for the NT Thunder.
Geez, it's been a hot start to the game already, hasn't it? You can tell that both clubs are really, really striving to get the 4 points here today. Thunder in the top 5 on percentage only, and Broadbeach a game outside the top 5. So very important for both teams today.
Give that to Quick over the top, but having some work to do here is Geary. He'll get a free kick for 2 high. And now it's going to be reversed. This is silly stuff there. Very silly by Jack Templeton, reversing the free kick. And it'll be a shot on goal. The first true shot on goal will go to Chris Dunn.
Yeah, Chris Dunn coming off a pretty good game for the NEAFL against the SANFL last week in Adelaide. Thunder had a record number of 7 representatives across the under-22s and seniors, and Chris Dunn bobbed up with 2 goals and looks like he's got a fairly good start to the day. No, just dropped short.
Just short, Jess. That was very close. Good thinking too by Quick to get back there on the last line of defence. Bad kick out. He'll have another crack here. Kick from Brown, and he's missed. He's missed to the left. So very sloppy start by the Cats. I thought they'd be a little bit cleaner here. We've been going 90 seconds, almost 2 minutes in to this first quarter.
Get over there, KB!
Kick comes in towards the broadcast side. They're hugging the boundary here, the Cats, but that's pretty clean. Mark taken by Hancock. And he'll kick towards the big fella in Brewer. There's a free kick here. Hands in the back. It'll go to the Thunder. That's a good matchup there. Lockwood on Brewer, but I feel as though Brewer will spend a bit of time in the ruck. Short kick has found Dunn, and he'll go back to Lockwood.
Jeez. Unusual to see Dunn so far up the ground, isn't it? Taking a mark there at true centre-half back position.
Sloppy kick here from Lockwood. Could be turned over. Emery. Was that too high? It was. So now the Cats with their first true chance of the day. The kick from Kieran Emery towards full forward. Yes, a big mark taken there by Mitch Brewer. Well, it was uncontested really, but he rose quite high. And so this will be a good start for the Cats.
Yeah, very smart there from Brewer. As soon as he saw that kick from Thunder didn't quite hit its target, he quickly got back into the forward line, lost Lockwood in the play, and when the ball was turned over, he had so much space on his opponent already that it turned out to be a relatively easy mark.
Mitch Brewer, the scraggy customer from the Cats. They love him here at the Cattery. H&A Oval, beautiful Saturday afternoon. He comes in for the Cats' first score, and it is a major. He's happy with that one. And Mitch Brewer with the first goal of the day. And the Cats, they lead now by 5 points. 1-6 to the Thunder, 1-7. So just 1 true inside 50 for a major score for the Cats, and that's a good start.
And you feel like Brewer's going to cause a lot of headaches for the Thunder side today. They don't really have a lot of tall options. They have Bugler is out, Farrah was a late withdrawal as well, and Jaden Pryor still hasn't come back into the side yet from a bit of injury and illness. So Thunder are lacking a lot of tall men, so it'll be interesting to see how they use Brewer because I feel like it can be a really great X factor for them.
The Cats are looking for back-to-back wins for the first time this year, after beating the Labrador Tigers last week by an even 6 goals. We await the ball to come back in here. Jess must have popped over into the river or the school out the back. Of course, Pacific Fair not too far away for those shopaholics out there, Jess.
Yeah, no, I didn't go to the shopping centre this morning.
I'll keep an eye on you at half time. You might sneak down there and get yourself something before you fly back home. But in the middle, Rosie's handball was chopped off, and now they're on again here. McKenzie got away from his opponent from 65. He goes for home. McKenzie! What a goal! He's kicked an absolute beauty from 65 metres, maybe with the aid of a slight breeze, but he's got the first. And just like that, the Cats have got two on the board and they lead by 11 points.
Yeah, it was inspiring stuff, wasn't it? A quick clearance, a great start from the Cats, and just to snatch that ball off Rosier. And geez, what a lovely finish from outside 50. It was a brilliant kick and a great start to the Cats. They'll be loving this.
We wait the ball to come back in. Well said there too, Jess. And beautiful conditions as well, H&A Oval. Hopefully it's coming up nicely on the screen, because the grass is fantastic out there. And they're putting on a spectacle so far. We're 3.5, 4 minutes in. First quarter, Rosier in the middle, got the handball from Islet and kicks towards Wanamere. And he's got it on a string out there from 60. Not the best of entries towards Ewing. Now a chance off the ground. It's a goal to the Thunder. I think it could be done. I think Dunn, yes, they're going to him with the high fives. Chris Dunn's got his first off the ground. 3 goals in 3 minutes. How do you like that? We've got a goal fest here at H&A.
Geez, it was just so clever from Dunn, wasn't it? He has that really great ability to make something out of nothing and bob up when Thunder really need him. But, geez, I thought it might have been touched, but obviously not along the ground. He has great goal sense as well. And, geez, Thunder, they needed to respond there, and they did it in style.
We spoke before we went on air today, Jess, about Austin Wanamere. He's one of those players you'd like to see a little bit more of.
Yeah, I think so. I think Wanamere in particular, Nalkin as well, on that forward line, I feel like they really need to take their game to another level today, because Thunder would really need that spark in their side today.
Ball back in the middle. Kieran Brennan doing the ruck work, but it's Staunton who gets them going forward. A loose footy here. Stewart has some work to do. Handball to Searle. And now a kick towards Nathan Quick. A push in the back, so he'll get a free kick. It goes against Micaiah Cockatoo. So Nathan Quick from defensive side of halfway goes towards half forward. It's at the back of the pack. Can they keep it in? They can. The handball came from Scott, and it was looking there for Hancock, but the kick came from Burton towards full forward. And a nice mark there from Lockwood, I believe. Now to Islet, in turn, Vernkamp, no, it'll be done out on the outer side, and he'll go short, maybe too short. Motlop, a little bit sloppy there, out of defence, so we'll have a boundary throw in.
Again, we see Dunn in that back pocket. He's covering a lot of ground. He's such a workhorse, and he's got a great engine on him, and already we've seen him go length of the ground a couple of times.
6 minutes in, there's a free kick here, Jess. It'll go to the Thunder. The Cats weren't too sure. It's not only a free kick, it'll be 50 metres as well. So the Thunder with a chance here. And that's a nice looking 50 metres too.
It's not bad, is it? Play that straight away.
And he goes towards full forward. Ewing! Of course, he kicked the bag here last time, Jess. We'll talk about that in a minute. The Cats' defence under pressure again. Can they get something out there? There's a free kick. Ben Wells. His short kick looking for Quick. Out of bounds. Boundary umpire was in a good spot. So we'll have a throw in here, Jess, of course. Darren Ewing.
Yeah, he kicked 9 goals last time. The last time Thunder beat Broadbeach was back in round 3, 2011. Can you believe Broadbeach had won the last 3 encounters? But Darren Ewing, I love this ground. I actually did a bit of a player diary on him last time, and it was really fascinating to see how he prepares for a game. He's a country lad, he doesn't do much, but and then he went and kicked 9 goals. It was a nice little story.
So Wanamere got the handball from Staunton, then got around a would-be tackler, takes 2 bounces from 55, nails it, goes for home, off hands, punch through. So starting to inject himself there, Aussie Wanamere. That's a good sign for the Thunder fans here on Thunder Vision. Hope you're enjoying it. 2 straight, plays 1-2, the margin 4 points. The Cats lead. Interesting kick. Oh, out of midair. Lux of fortune. Wolseley Black has got it on the chest. Who's marked it out there, Jess? The kick came in. That's a nice looking kick. So Nalkin has marked.
It was Philip Wills who mark that kick out of midair from Aaron Worsley-Black. It's good to see him get a couple of games under his belt as well, after he toured Europe with the AIS AFL Academy. And he's a great young talent from Central Australia, and he's got a massive future.
Baden Nalkin from the pocket. It was a direct approach, but unfortunately didn't get the purchase on it to get over the man on the mark. And now it'll be Matt Fife. Pops it over the top. Has that gone the required? No. It'll be Fife again. Oh, now great tackle. That's holding the footy. The Thunder with the free kick. Shannon Rioli told to play on by the umpire. Goes backwards to VV. Or it might have been Vernkum. Teeth of goal. They're a chance. Rosier all wrapped up. Gee, they're under some pressure here. Immense pressure, the Cats back line. Can they get it out of trouble? No, they cannot. Nalkin, yes. Baden Nalkin from the pocket. They deserve that one. The small forwards for the Thunder are getting on top. Goals to Dunn, and now Nalkin, and they've hit the front.
Yeah, it was great work by Nalkin. Geez, talk about a big future. He certainly has one. He was named in the Northern Conference squad for the rep game last week, but didn't make the final cut. But he comes from Outback in Central Australia, a tiny community of Hermannsburg. And to start his NEAFL career, he's done extremely well, but it was great forward pressure there from Thunder, which is something they really try and pride themselves on for those and to create those opportunities that we just saw.
Both teams making a lot of changes there as that goal went through. As we approach the 9-minute mark of this first quarter, the Cats trying to get it out of the middle. Walton, they work it backwards to Stewart. He bangs it on the boot. Now they've got 2-on-1 out here, the Cats. Smith is the only Thunder, and he might win the footy for them, and he does. Fantastic stuff, Chris Smith. Couldn't quite get enough on the handball, so the Cats will pump it inside 50. Where are the Flyers? Emery! Kieran Emery's one of them from the side of the pack, waltzes in and marks directly in front, 30 out from goal.
Yeah, he just read that better, didn't he? You can tell that he just judged the flight of the ball perfectly and ended up taking up a great grab. And the second time we've seen today is a big Broadbeach forward take a grab inside 50.
Mitch Brewer was the first of those, and he kicked the first goal. Can Kieran Emery kick the third for the Cats? He comes in. That's a nice-looking kick. The goal umpire has not moved. She puts the two guns up. Thank you very much. Goal to the Cats. They've got three straight. Three straight. 18 plays. 2-2-14. Margin is 4 points. Matt Ridley here, joined with Jess Webster. We're 12 minutes into the first quarter. Round 9, courtesy of Thunder Vision.
And, geez, it's been a great start to the game, hasn't it? I think we've got a shootout on our hands at the moment. Both sides love to play some free-flowing football, and it's really great to see. Got a lot of young players in both sides as well. So we're seeing a great game of footy at the moment.
Umpire Crunk has the ball in hand. The ruckman will go at it. Margin is 4 points. So Mitch Brewer's in the ruck now. In fact, the umpire will bring this one back. Neil Veve had no chance there. They do it all again. VV over the top, give that to him. And they come to the broadcast side here, the Cats. Stewart, look out! Big tackle there from Motlop. Motlop going at it again with VV. It spills out towards McKenzie. And there as well is Scott. Rosier burrows his way through, and then he's allowed to stand up and then gets a clean kick towards half forward. Tumbling ball. Nelkin's there. So 2-5. They come backwards to Searle. Eventually a handball to Templeton. Now on the left boot. He gets it towards centre wing. Goes through the hands of Cockatoo. Close to the boundary line. Pantic. Over the line and out of bounds. This is good football, folks. Three straight 18 to 2-2-14. Margin is 4 points.
Yeah, it certainly is. The intensity is high. You can just tell that this game is a classic 8-point contest, isn't it? And both sides have started off with a bang, and it's great footy.
Close to the boundary line. Islet. Handball, a cheeky one. Found Nalkin. That's a nice kick to Rosier. Turns on a three-bitty bit. Kicks it into the middle. Brown. Kicks to a long, long lead from Ewing. Gets it on the bounce. Tries to get away from his opponent and then kicks it towards back in board. Yes, mark taken here by Nathan Brown.
Beautiful play there from Thunder. Look, it started with that pinpoint pass from Nalkin to set up, to, you know, j- just get the possession in their hands. But it was great work from Nathan Brown. And once he kicked that ball to Ewing, he made sure he ran inside 50 to create another option. Ended up getting it back, and now he's got a shot on goal. So it was great work right there.
He's directly in front here, Jess. He'll kick from 40 metres. This will put the Thunder back in front from 45. It's on its way. Has he got enough on it? No! The second time this quarter that they've been caught short going for goal, the Thunder. So there might be a bit of a breeze out there. We're sitting in a beautiful commentary box here, Jess, but I think there might be a bit of a breeze just favouring the left of screen as the Cats bring it in. Brewer, Verncombe at the front, Stewart. So Stewart has marked. This will go down the wire, I think, this game. This will be a true fourth quarter game. That's a nice mark in front of Benny Rioli, the mark taken by Taylor Haley. The lead's come out, but he elects to go across the ground. Back to Stewart, trying to create a loose man here. Fife, and now they link up by hand. And on the outer side, the kick there came from Crawford. He keeps running, but the Cats, they go forward, looking there for Seal. I should have said Searle. Smith. Now the Thunder, they run it out. A long kick from Worsley Black towards half forward. Oh, Boof Ewing came out like a Bondi tram. Getting back Crawford. He wants the free kick. Nothing doing. Fife. Back to Stewart. Now the Cats. Under pressure again here, the Cats. Has to do some work. Is Ben Wells. And he did well, didn't he? Benny boy. A kick on the left boot. Oh, well-weighted kick to Ben Hancock. Rioli stands the mark. Off a step. Hancock towards the big fella there in Brennan. Good work by Lockwood. And he might get it here, Lockwood. He will on the bounce. Oh, tumbling ball straight through his legs. Unfortunate. The kick came from Smith. But what a game, Jess. I am on the edge of my seat, and we are only 15 minutes in first quarter. It is the Cats by 3 points.
It's just going a million miles an hour. The intensity is great. The tackling, the pressure is great from both sides. We're seeing some bursts of play where, Thunder have had more scoring shots on goal, but every time Broadbeach goes forward, it has a really nice open forward line, and they're creating opportunities for themselves. It's just a great spectacle.
Up high there was Verncombe over Brewer. The umpire might have to come in and do it again. He does. Goals to Dunn and Nelken for the Thunder. They trail by 3 points. Verncombe again got high. Islet, he'll get a free kick here. He was held before he got the football. In fact, it's not Islet, it's Brad Vassell. Vassell out wider. That's a beautiful kick. Motlop. You're looking for options here.
Hancock, 45.
Goes to the scoreboard side.
21.
Mark taken by Argus. The Cats by 3 points. Midway through the first quarter. Staunton. Now they've got a loose man out here. It's Cockatoo. Cockatoo can go to VV. He does. So possession footy, trying to get the overlap, trying to create a loose man. Staunton in the middle. He plays on quickly, kicks it inboard. Mark taken here by Vassell. Maybe too far out to score.
Not quite sure Staunton meant that kick, but I think it just fell into Vassell's lap. Let's see what he can do with it here.
He's told to play on now. He's not sure as the Cats get back in numbers. To Wanamary, a chiselling ball, beautiful kick. Mark taken inside 50. And looks like Brown.
Yep, it was another a really well-worked passage of play from Thunder. Rather than blazing away to the goal square, Vassell just had that ability to hold things up and go for the right option. And he went a bit wider to Wanamiri and used his brilliant skills to set up Brown and a shot on goal. And you feel like if they would have gone long, it would have been rushed behind or Broadbeach with their height and strength may have won possession back. So it was very smart.
So Brown's kick, that's a nice looking kick. They deserve to be in front of the Thunder. And now they are in front by 3 points. 3-3, 21 to 3 straight 18. And Jess, we're 18 minutes in first quarter. Hope you're enjoying the action here on Thunder Vision. Brought to you live, bringing you the magic of NEAFL football. The Thunder by 3 points, goals to Dunn, Nelken, and now Nathan Brown.
Third lead change for the quarter already, and It just goes to show it's end-to-end stuff, and each team just keeps trading blows. And like we keep mentioning, it's just been a great start to the game. It's free-flowing. It's a beautiful day here in Broadbeach. The ground is nice and quick and fast, and we're just seeing great game footy.
Umpire Cronk gets us back underway. Give that to VV over the top. Rosier, and now to Wanamary. They swing it out wider. This is Motlop. Short kick. Now they pop it over the top. Good defence there from the Cats. I think it might have been Ben Wells. He's in everything at the moment, Ben Wells. Umpire's seen a free kick here. It'll go to the Thunder. So they're a chance again.
He's probably taken a little high before, and the umpire missed that free kick, I think, but Vassal ended up getting one for in the back anyway. So
Brad Vassal looks for options. The Cats are getting back there, so that's what they're doing here, the Thunder. They're just a little 20-metre kick instead of the 40-metre kick, because the Cats are creating a wall about 20 out from goal, and now this, I think, is Chris Dunn.
And I'll back him in here. For this one, he's a lovely set shot on goal.
He's already got one. Can he add to that and increase this Thunder lead? Margin is 3 points. 20 minutes in now, first quarter. Chris Dunn for his second of the quarter. Yes, he likes it. And the Thunder sneak away here. They lead by 9 points, 4-3-27 to 3-18. We've had 7 goals kicked in 20 minutes of footy, but Dunn, he's got the... Chris Dunn, he's now got 2 goals in the first quarter. He adds his name next to Brown, Nathan Brown and Baden Nelk, and they've got one each. I think they deserve to be in front, and I think that's a true reflection of the game thus far, Jess.
I think they've really showed their skills. I think that's what's been missing, I think, for the first part of the season is Thunder skills probably haven't been to the level that we expect them to be, but we're seeing at the moment they're patient, they're not blazing away, they know they're undersized and understrength, and they're just trying to play to their strengths at the moment, but really executing their skills, which I think is something that's been missing so far. So it's been a great start for the Territory.
Neither side can get it out of the middle here, so the umpire will come in. Do it all again. Vassal, VV, Rosier, Islet. They're all in there, and Staunton for the Thunder. The handball's a bit loose, and now getting away from his opponent here is Nick Scott. Kicks it towards full forward. Emery at the back, couldn't quite mark. Lockwood, handball to Rioli, and from the defensive 50, that's a lovely kick to Motlop. Now they've got the run. Motlop, he could have used Shannon Rioli, elects to take a bounce. Back in board to Rosier, and he was caught. A little bit of indecisive there from the Thunder. Pantic wrestling it out of there was Wolseley Black, but then he's all sold up. VV, umpire says I'll have it. I just thought they might have got away there, the Thunder.
Yeah, I thought they were too. They just kind of stuffed it up a little bit, perhaps didn't get the overlap or a lack of communication. But that's all right. They haven't lost possession. They've just got a ball up.
22 minutes gone, first quarter. Pantic uses Stewart. He's got more room to move than he thought, but he elects to go long with this breeze. It's a wrestle, and that's a mark. Beautiful one-on-one mark there to Kieran Brennan. And it's the Talls of the Cats forward line, as you said, Emery, Brennan and Brewer, creating some minor headaches for the Thunder.
Yeah, Thunder, they are missing a couple of tools. Justin Bugler did his ankle quite badly in the last game against Morningside, so he's out for a few weeks. As you see, Broadbeach just bring the margin back to a little closer, and of course Jaden Pryor is still yet to come back into the side. He's battled a bit of injury and illness as well. And Thunder, they're just short in the big men department, I think. And Lockwood, you can tell just how important he is. I mean, he's already had a few possessions today, and he's just going to need a really, really big game, I think, today to be able to stop as many of those contested marks as possible.
Well, they needed that one, the Cats. The Thunder were just sneaking away a little bit on them there, but the margin back to 3 points, 4-3. Thankfully, they're kicking straight, the Cats. On their home dunghill here at H&A Oval, Broadbeach, thanks to Thunder Vision. Matt Ridley is joined with Jess Webster. It's been a cracking opening. 23 minutes in, first quarter. The umpire's happy to let things go there. McKenzie couldn't quite get it out. a hurried kick. It might have been touched off the boot, but the Cats have got the numbers here. Geary, his handball was chopped off by Wanamary. He takes a bounce. Handball over the top to Staunton. A handball back in board to Nelken. He was run down from behind, and then his kick has hit the point post. So good desperation stuff by the Cats defence, just as Nelken was going in to kick his second, Jess. And we've got a free kick out of bounds on the full, of course. Crawford kicks it in. We've got a player down to the left of screen. Keep an eye on that, Jess, as I'll call the play. Over to Kirk Quick. Looking to get it. It's 2-on-1 out there. If the Cats can somehow get it over the line, he does that. Good work. Well done there by Nick Scott, I should say, to force it over the line and out of bounds.
Yeah, still trying to identify that Cats player coming off the bench, coming off the ground, sorry, at the moment. Doesn't look anything too serious. Looks like it's Adam McConaughey, and I think he might have just copped a heavy knock coming off for a bit of a spell.
So the Cats will go forward again. Looking for a free kick there was Haley. He might get it though. Can he get a clean handball out? Eventually it spills out. 50 out from goal for the Cats. They'll get a free kick. And with the aid of a slight breeze to the left, this might be a chance at goal. They trail by 3 points, 24 minutes in. Adam McConaughey it is on the bench getting some attention. The kick to the pocket, it was chopped off. Boundary throw in.
Desperation at one end and desperation at the other from Josh Chaplin there. Just did everything he could to get across there and spoil that lead. Did it very well.
So boundary throw in. Deep in attack, the Cats. Are we looking to get their fifth on the board? Handball came out. 50 out from goal. A lot of players around the footy. No clean possession. McKenzie was looking for Pantic. Beautiful work. Wanamary, Nelken back to Aussie. Back in board to Baden. And here they go. A bounce. Two bounces. Nelken through the middle of H&A Oval. He wants Boof to lead that way. Boof, and he does. He's got three to beat. Ewing couldn't quite beat them all. Stewart. And now the kick. Comes back in board to Callan Geary. Long kick towards Hancock. One-on-one with Argus. Good work by Hancock. An off a step. He goes towards Brennan. In fact, it's not Brennan. It's Nathan Quick. Goes long towards Brewer. One-on-one with Lockwood. Brewer couldn't quite mark. Coming in from the side is Josh Searle. Searle on the left boot. Tumbles through. It's a goal. Bouncing through. It is a goal. The Cats are back in front.
Jesus, great footy to watch, isn't it? We just saw at one end of the ground that beautiful passage of play from Thunder, Wanamiri and Nolkin, and we thought, oh, Boof, he's got a chance. I thought it was a smart kick from Nolkin too, just to put it in space. That's where Boof likes it, and just that patch of grass over his shoulder. We just couldn't quite beat three of them. And then that great passage of play from Broadbeach coming the other way. Another great contest between Lockwood and Brewer, and then just at the fall of the ground there, lovely roving and a great finish, and the ball just kind of bounced over Vernkham's head there, but end-to-end stuff, and it's just great to watch, isn't it?
And some smart coaching too at the moment from Matt Angus, creating an open forward line for the talls to be one-on-one against Lockwood there. You've got Brewer, Brennan, and also Emery against Lockwood in the one-on-one. So I'm sure Daniel Archer will have a look at that at quarter time. This is Motlop. The handball came from Wills, but it's chopped off, and the Cats are out here. McConaughey, he's got room. He hasn't got the confidence, but he goes towards Brewer. He couldn't mark. Tumbling ball towards the boundary line. Lockwood kept it in. One-on-one. Vernkham couldn't quite mark. McConaughey again. Now he's caught. He's just lost that confidence. Inboard. Wills. Out wider. Motlop. He's been busy. Short kick. Well weighted. Oh, it's come off the knee of Dunn. Back to Motlop. So centre wing. 27 minutes in first quarter. Margin 3 points. The Cats lead. This is, I think it was Dunn. Kick towards the pocket, but it's all the Cats coming out. Crawford was well tackled. Now they're a chance here, the Thunder. Will they lead? 28 minutes in. Ewing boots it through the middle. And the Buff's got his first. Now the Thunder are back in front. Jess, keep adding that up. The Cats, five straight 30. to the Thunder. 5-3-33. Margin is 3 points. Jess, how many lead changes in this first turn?
Yeah, unbelievably. We've already had five. After the first couple, I thought, oh, geez, I'll just keep a tally on my notepad to see how this pans out. But five already in the first quarter. It's turning into be a real game, and like we mentioned at the start of the call, that we think it's going to go down to the wire, and so far it's panning out that way. It's a great brand of footy from both sides, and it'll be really interesting to see who comes out on top. I just don't want it to end.
Well, the first quarter will end soon. 28 minutes in. Brennan jumped too early. VV getting through there is Pantic, but he hit a brick wall. We'll have a throw up or a bounce down. Just on the attacking side of halfway for the Cats. Brennan and VV again, and Pantic. Couple of cracks at the cherry, and that's quarter time. What a ring-ding battle it was. The Cats lead 5 straight 30 to 5-3-33. Both sides will go into their huddles. Goals two. On the Broadbeach Cats, Emery, McKenzie, Searle, Brennan and Brewer. They've all got singles. Why for the NT Thunder, two goals to Chris Dunn and one each to Brown, Ewing and Nelken. To sum it up quickly, Jess Webster.
I think Broadbeach's goals, you were seeing that they're keeping a great open forward line and really using their tools to their advantage. You've already seen a couple of contested marks, or if not 50-50 contests, where a Broadbeach player's managed to get to the full of the ball and create a scoring opportunity. And then you look at Thunder, who obviously a bit shorter here today, but are really smart, I feel, with their forward entries, which is something that I haven't probably seen so far this season, is the way that they're just being patient when they go inside forward 50. And like you said, those little 20-metre kicks just to kind of hold things up and not blaze long, and I think it's working well for them, and Broadbeach's gameplay is working well for them at the moment, so it's about who can sustain it for the longest, I feel.
Thank you very much, Jess Webster. Join with Matt Ridley, and I hope you can join us after the quarter time break for the round 9 battle, the Cats and the Thunder, who lead by 3 points.
Your team.
Our time.
Sign up as an NT Thunder member for 2013 and help support your territory team. Family and corporate memberships are available. For full membership package details, visit the Thunder website.
Welcome back to H&A Oval. About to commence the second quarter here, the round nine battle between the Cats and the Thunder. The Broadbeach Cats in the blue and white will kick to the right of screen, and the Thunder to the left. And VV up against Brennan in the ruck. It'll be the Thunder who will get them going forward early, but the Cats with an answer. A handball came from Geary, it is here. Kick towards the forward line. Getting back, Wolseley Black couldn't quite mark Rioli. Really nice in close stuff there with Islet. Now a kick to Rosier. Just got it on the bounce there. Snap around the body to Wanamiri. In pursuit there was Pantic. Hit kick here has found Chris Cooper. So Cooper on the right forward flank. The lead came out from Ewing. And a good pocket for the left footer. And Ewing will have the first true shot on goal. And we're in the side, the first minute of this second term. The Thunder by 3 points. He's already got one. Ewing snaps it round. He likes it. So does the goal umpire. What a goal from the pocket. Darren Ewing's got two. And the Thunder now with the first goal of the second term, the all-important one, and that kicks them out to 9-point lead.
Geez, nice to see that we picked up where we left off. A beautiful passage of play from Thunder that Rioli and Islet there on the halfback flank that set it up. And Chris Cooper on debut. Nice to see him take a mark and spot up Ewing on the lead as well. He's another Central Australian product as well. So got a couple of them in the side today, and it's good to see the talent continues to come out of Alice Springs. So well done.
Ball back in the middle. The Thunder now by 9 points. Nine scoring shots to five. They probably deserve to be a little bit further ahead here. The Cats are keeping them very honest. Walton gave the don't argue. Now they've got the advantage here, the Cats. So through the middle of H&A Oval, they go to the forward flank. Geary read it better. Handball to Fife. Now Fife will kick it towards the pocket. It's a one-on-one. The kick not the best for Emery. Now there's a free kick. It'll go to the Thunder here. Getting up a little bit gingerly there is Cameron Islet. And Islet kicks it out wider. So they've got the numbers here. Smith. He wants Lockwood to keep running for him. Smith takes on big Mitch Brewer. And look at them go. Good work by Mitchie Brewer to keep in tow. But Smith, he's taken three. He's taken four bounces. And now a long kick towards Ewing again. Off hands. Over the line and out of bounds, and I bet you what, Mitch Brewer will be sucking in the big ones after chasing Chris Smith on the outer wing.
Geez, didn't he take off? He just went forever. You were wondering when he was going to stop. But good play from Chris Smith to take them on, and you're going to need a lot of that run coming out of the back off of Thunder. It's where a lot of their strength and drive comes from.
And they're deep in attack here too, the Thunder. They're a chance. Can they get goal number seven on the board? Stewart, it is out of defence for the Cats. Over the top. The two number 17s, Pantic, Rioli. Pantic's little kick at favoured Vassal, and he's taken a mark. Two kicks from home for the Thunder. Vassal, a studded approach, and then another one of those short kicks. Rosier from 55, sizes them up. Ewing at the back. He's given away a free kick here. A little bit of a nudge as the ball was on its way. So it'll be the Cats. We're four and a half minutes in. Second quarter. Wells in the pocket here. Not sure where to go here, Wells. So across the face of goal to the outer side. I think that might have been Nick Alice. Now Stewart. Alice keeps running for him and he get it now. The handball was a bit of a hospital one. Wanamary kicks towards Nelken, gets it on the bounce. This is trouble for the Cats. Nelken from the pocket. What a ripper. Baden Nelken's got his second. And the Thunder have got two in 4 minutes of this second quarter.
Geez, wasn't it great? Ewing snap from the pocket from a set shot, and then Nelken as well. What a finish. It just goes to show what incredible skills he has. I love watching him dispose of the footy because I feel like it brings back memories of Ross Tungatalum and how amazing he was for Thunder in the NEAFL competition. And geez, again, Thunder, they've started the second quarter off with a bang. I think they were lucky to get the ball back because I felt like that previous entry just going long to Ewing. I don't think that's going to work for them today. They really need to be smarter. And they managed to just hurt Broadbeach on the rebound there. And what a great finish.
Thank you, Jess Webster, here on Thunder Vision. The Thunder are out to a handy 15-point lead. They're under pressure again by handball. So McKenzie, Pantic, and now Stewart for the Cats. A bit of a tumbling ball on the outer side. Walton will get there first. A hurried kick towards Pantic. He's got a couple to beat. He's spun out of trouble. Now on the outer side, the kick towards Emery. Can he get it in time? Over the line and out of bounds, so we'll have a throw in. The Thunder by 15 points. We're 6 minutes into the second quarter.
And we mentioned as well how important this game is for both clubs. Thunder are one of three on on 12 points on the ladder. The people below them on percentage, Aspley and Gold Coast, are each well ahead of their opponents. Aspley are about 60 points in front of Tuggeranong, and Gold Coast about 40 points at the moment ahead of Morningside. So Thunder need a win, otherwise they're going to drop outside the top five.
Yes, it is a very big game. Who will take the 4 points here? Hancock leaves it for his teammate. They try and spoon it out. Walton's there as well. Hancock will go again. On the outer side, the Cats. Long kick, I think, came from Nick Scott towards full forward. Emery on the bounce. Handball was chopped off. But there's still a chance. An underground handball. Emery's shot at goal. It was chopped off right in the 10-metre allowance there by Rioli. Popped it over the top to Argus. Now the Thunder are a chance here. Motlop had to sit and hope. He should have got a free kick there, but he didn't. And then the handball from Fife put his teammate under pressure. He'll go again, Fife. Pantic was there. Now the turnover. And they're away here. Vassal over the top to Cooper. He's played on, but the Cats slipped over there, Stewart. Cooper on debut towards full forward. Nelken with the push. Oh, he's been paid the push. The hands in the back there. They're under a lot of pressure here, the Cats. Can they hold strong here as we're 7 minutes in? Second quarter. They're under some pressure again. Close to the boundary line. In fact, it's kept in play. No, it isn't. It's over the line and out of bounds. It's a kick from Wells. Hit his opponent. Oh, goodness. We're 8 minutes in. The Cats have not scored in this second term.
Yeah, you really feel like Thunder are taking a stranglehold on this contest at the moment. They're really putting a lot of pressure. They've upped the ante here at the moment, and it's up to Broadbeach now to respond.
Kick towards centre wing. It's a one-on-one out here. Hancock's out there. Might have given away a free kick on Cockatoo. Broadbeach. This is through, I think that might be Greeley, but they've coughed it up. Kick towards Dunn. Handball back. Rosier. Kick inboard. No mark there, but it goes to Fife. And I think you're right, Jess. This game could really open up in the next 5 minutes if it goes the Thunder's way. Fife takes a bounce, then kicks it towards Nathan Quick. Yeah, they've got the overlap here. I'm not sure if they can get it to him, though. The kick from Quick. Geary. Vassal. Also there is, yes, it's over the line, is it? No, we might have a bounce down. Wolseley Black was there as well for the Thunder.
It was good play from Thunder just to slow Broadbeach up there, because you're right, they did have the overlap, but it was a good work rate just to hold it up here on the wing and not let them get some space to be able to run and carry into their forward line.
We're approaching the 10-minute mark of the second quarter. The Cats have not scored in the second term. Brennan in the ruck. Vassell's there in tight quarters. Fife. Handball to Brennan. A hurried handball. Up and under there was Greeley. And now this is Wills. Handball to Staunton. Got some room to move. Goes for home. The kick not favouring Ewing. Getting back there was Crawford. Ewing almost got it. Off the ground. And that was close. We've got a minor score there to Buff Ewing.
Geez, a bit of a let off there for the Cats, because Staunton's kick, Ewing was actually leading into the pocket, but Staunton's kick kind of went across the face of goal and he had to double back. But geez, he almost got a goal out of it anyway. Thunder have really put the pressure on the Cats this quarter, and like you said, here we go, here's another chance.
Kick on goal, and it is a good one here for the Thunder. Could be Cockatoo.
Sure is.
Nakia Cockatoo has got his first, and the Thunder have kicked three goals in 10 minutes of this second term to open this up. So that will make it 8-4 to 5 straight. 8-4, 52, margin 22 points.
And Cockatoo, in just his third game for Thunder, is a young 16-year-old. Part of the AIS AFL Academy as well. He's a bright spark for the Territory at the moment. Got a huge future ahead of him. And he comes back into the side after a few weeks out. But it's good to see him get his opportunity and make the most of it.
Ball back in the middle. Brewer. Handball here. It's found Wills. He's all wrapped up. You feel as though the Cats need the next here. Otherwise, it'll be out to 28 to almost three-goal lead if the Thunder can get the next. Eilert was there. Handball came out towards Greeley. They're going backwards. Stewart under some pressure. Now a kick out here. Looks for Quick. Did well. Oh, gee, I don't like that. He's been paid the free kick here, Motlop.
Yeah, just a second too long, you're right. It's a technicality, but it's pretty harsh when you hold on to the play for just a second longer than you have to. Good. Yeah, I'm giving away the free kick.
Good kick there by Motlop, but off hands. VV fed the handball. 50 out from goal. VV goes again. Good work, Neil Jr. Rozier. Good tackle. Now this is Stevenson in game number two for the Cats. Argus was dispossessed, but he goes again. Handball out towards Cooper. Just overrun it a little bit. So too did Stewart. The bodies fly in. And the umpire will put whistle to mouth and says, I'll have it. 40 out from goal for the Thunder. They lead by 22 points, 12 minutes in, second quarter.
Jesus, good footy, isn't it? It's really in tight and close, and Broadbeach are under the pump at the moment, and they really need to try and get a breakaway here and just stem the flow.
Tumbling ball. Is it off hands? It's off the feet. In fact, it's a goal. Another one sockered through for the Thunder. And everything's going their way in this second quarter.
It's Chris Dunn for his third. Just Cooper there just hacked the ball forward, really, and Dunn was just managed to get boot to ball for his third goal. And as we see the margin just creep out, and geez, Thunder is full of confidence at the moment. They're applying great pressure. Their skills are on point today, which is, as you mentioned earlier, probably hasn't quite seen that kind of great skill execution so far this year. So they're playing some really good football at the moment, probably the best that I've seen them play all year.
They've kicked the first four goals of this second quarter in the space of 13 minutes to set up a 28-point lead. 9-4 for the Thunder to 5 straight. 13 scoring shots to 5. Margin is 28 points. It's far from over, but this is a pretty handy lead for the Thunder. We approach the midway stages of the second term.
They do love this ground, Thunder. Last time they played, he was in the preliminary final last year against Southport to get into the grand final. They had another handy win. And, of course, the last time they played here, they won by about 64 points against Broadbeach. So it's they do like this ground. It's nice and big and open for them. It's a great deck as well. Fantastic weather. It's perfect conditions for the dry, skillful footy that the Territory are renowned for.
A kick from Stewart towards half forward. We haven't seen it down to the right-hander of the screen too many times in this term. Greeley picked it up. That's better. Nice kick. And a mark taken by Hancock at full forward. In fact, the kick came from Nick Burton. And I think Hancock is marked here, and he'll have a shot on goal.
I think they've done very well so far in this game, Broadbeach. They're so efficient when they go forward. They look great when they're into their forward 50. It's just obviously about shutting it down the other way.
They just haven't seen it go down there too many occasions. That's a nice kick. And Ben Hancock has got his first for the day. And gee whiz, if the Cats ever needed a goal, it was right there. Six straight, 36 to 9-4, 28. Margin back to 22 points. And this is a fantastic game of footy. I really think this will still go down to the wire. Hancock's got his first.
And as we mentioned for Broadbeach earlier, they're a game outside the top five. And with it looks like Aspley and Gold Coast are going to have wins this afternoon. They're in comfortable positions in their clashes at the moment. So it's a game that Broadbeach, if they lose, they're going to be two games outside. Or still one game outside the top five. Obviously, they're playing Thunder, but...
The ball in the middle. Vassal, Staunton, now to the running Rioli. Here go the Thunder again. Got it to Argus. This way, that way. Kicks it, centres it. Off hands. Stewart, handball over the top. Greeley just sliding his way, and then he was caught high. Absolutely coat hanging, so he'll get a free kick. Can the Cats get back-to-back goals and get back into this contest? Greeley goes wide. Quick. Quick will go short to the leading players, Pantic or Brewer. Brewer marked, and so he'll kick it close to the boundary, and now it's over the line and out of bounds. Just the attacking side of halfway for the Thunder. 22 points the margin. The Thunder lead. We're 16 minutes in. Second quarter. Brewer and Vernkham, falls down to Walton, a quick kick, it'll fall in the hands of Geary. Good work, Motlop. Handball to Smith, he'll go back to Rioli. Rioli, a little bit of an underground, and we'll have a boundary throw in.
Almost paid off for him, but he was surrounded by Cats there, it was Rioli, but... You see Motlop there coming back into the side. He's battled injury and illness this year. We haven't quite seen him hit his stride yet. He's had a pretty good start to the game so far today.
Walton got the handball to Nick Scott. And then a quick kick. That's not the very good kick. He should have ran a little bit longer. Wolseley Black, it was. Onto that favoured left boot. That's a spearing kick. Out of defence. Wanamiri took it and played on. And then kicks it out wider. Fife's got to go here. He's got two to beat Matty Fife. Staunton was one of those. A kick towards the forward 50. Mark taken here by Dunn. He's already got three. Dunn, short kick. That was a bit risky. Play on the call. Gee whiz, Haley thought he took the mark, but the Cats might run away with it here. Pantic. He panicked. And out wider to Burton. He'll get it on the bounce. Handball over the top. Now they're a chance. Hancock.
Plenty of space to work with here.
If they can keep it in, though, Jess, the boundary line was just too close for them. So we'll have a throw in. But you feel as though, well, I do. I feel as though the next goal's pretty important. Can the Cats get a bit of momentum and kick back-to-back goals?
Yeah, I think keeping them in it at the moment, six straight goals, it's a wonderful return. They can keep that up all day. I mean, obviously, the key to the game is kicking more goals than points, isn't it? But if you get a return like that, you're doing very well.
Kick from Hancock towards the pocket. We need more from Emery than for the Cats fans. Over the line and out of bounds. I think Josh Chaplin it was that saw it over. So we'll have a throw in. And we are 18 minutes in, second quarter. They're deep in attack. Can they get goal number seven on the board and bridge that margin back? This is an interesting spot. Handball came out. Snap around the corner. He's got it, has he? It's a goal. Pantic.
Oh.
Well, hold on a second. The goal umpire and the field umpire were in the... Yep, there we go. So it's a goal. But that's okay. The field umpire came in and said, are you sure? Are you positive that's a goal? The goal umpire said, yes, I am. And so 6 points to the Cats.
And we said the next goal was important, so the goal, the umpires just wanted to make sure that it was
they
a true
me.
Goal. Yep.
They heard me, Jess. So I was reading an article in that, whatever it is, that little record that we got about Ryan Pantic approaching game number 100 for in the NEAFL. Of course, he started at the Redland Bombers. Now he's almost up to game number 100. And gee, I think he'd be in his early 20s too, Ryan Panting. He's got a bright future here in southeast Queensland. And we just saw Wyatt with a beautiful snap over the left shoulder, keeping his Cats in this contest. Margin 16 points, 7 straight to 9-4. And they're going forward again. Can they get a kick inside 50? Greeley all wrapped up like a beef Wellington. 19 minutes in. Oh, that's making me hungry. We're approaching halftime.
I just thought about halftime as well, going, yeah, I'm getting a bit hungry too myself.
Here go the Cats. Oh, great work by Neil Vivi with the smother. Fife, kick around the corner. Now Luck's going the Cats way. Mark taken by Searle. Someone tell him to go back and have a shot on goal. I think someone just yelled that out. So Josh Searle, he's got one. Can he kick a second? The Thunder with some injury concerns here as we're into time on second quarter. Searle comes in. He'll kick from 55. He'll have to get every bit of it. He hasn't struck it best. Emery at the back. He's a right footer. He'll want to play on. You have to keep an eye on this one. They only just snuck through a snap a minute and a half ago. Emery off a step. He's missed the first minor score for the Cats. But once again, the intensity's beefed up a little bit here in the last 5 minutes. A kick comes into Wanamary.
And we saw Josh Chaplin coming off before. Geez, he's very unlucky. He's had a lot of problems with his shoulders and whatnot. I hope he's, it looks like he was hobbling on his ankle or his knee. Hopefully it's not too serious, but we can see him back out there soon.
The Cats go forward. The Thunder are getting back though in numbers. Mark taken by Smith. He'll pop it over the top. They've got a loose player. Islet has marked. And he'll go towards Lockwood. The kick not the best. Bounces back inboard. This is Haley. Pops it over the top. Great tackling out there. 50 out from goal for the Cats.
Yeah, great tackle from Benny Rioli, wasn't it? Just to wrap him up, because I felt like the Cats were away. They did have a bit of space there, and he saved a certain shot on goal, that's for sure.
I've got a question for you in a minute, Jess, so be prepared. I'll do it now. Now, Chaplin's come off. That's Chaplin over there.
Mm-hmm.
I'm not sure he came through the interchange gates. I think he's just been rushed off in the back pocket there. So I'll have to get an update at quarter time as to whether he came off through the interchange gates. I'm not sure. I'm just saying I'll have to pick that one up. So the kick here, Rioli to Smith.
I'm just on a quick head count. I can only count 17 on the field at the moment, so not quite sure if he's even been replaced.
What's happening here at H&A Oval? We are 22 minutes in second quarter. The Thunder are getting something going here. Neil Vivi just dropped what he should have taken in the middle, but they might get it back. Islet's in there. Strong tackling from both sides. Jake Greeley. That's a free kick. Okay.
He signalled the wrong way, but he must have said umpire it was a Thunder. Yeah,
I think that's gone against the Cats in the middle. Umpire Cronk signalled the wrong way. And now it'll be the Thunder with the free kick here for holding the footy. It'll go to Brown. Quick kick. One-on-one. Getting back there and doing the punch there was Templeton. Now they're under pressure here. Burton. Just have to steady things up here.
I think Broadbeach have done that well just in the last 5 or 10 minutes. Thunder obviously got that quick start to start this quarter. They've done well just to kind of level it at the moment, and I think they go on to halftime after the way that Thunder started this quarter. They'll be very happy they've kept in touch.
And we're approaching halftime too. We're 24 minutes in. Second quarter. Both sides are still making plenty of changes. Warm conditions here. 25, 26, 27 degrees. Cannot believe you're in a jumper too, Jess.
It's like, warm, I don't think so.
Handball from Vassell. Verncombe's handball was chopped off by Pantic, and he might have been seemingly legged. Play on. Stewart kicked it into space, and he said, Nick Burton, chase after it, you can have it. Handball over the top. It bounces kindly here from Templeton. Kick towards Big Mitch Brewer. That's a nice kick from Jack Templeton. And he found Brewer. Now Brewer fancies his chances in the pocket. I know we say it a lot, Jess, but the Cats need this. I just feel as though they're getting the momentum back in their favour in this second part of the second quarter. Margin is 15.
He'd be the first multiple goal scorer for the Cats as well. They've had 7 individual goal scorers, which I think is a great return as well to have so many contributors.
From right on 50, he got under it a little bit. The goal umpire likes it. So too do the Cats supporters. Brewer's got his second. 8-1 to 9-4. Margin back to 9 points. They've kicked the last 3 of the match.
Yeah, it was a great way for them to respond, wasn't it? It was a beautiful kick from Brewer as well. Just gives them that confidence going into halftime, going, we're still in this contest. They've done well to peg back Thunder, who started off this quarter with a bang. And we're back to that shootout that we had in the first quarter.
You touched on the defence of the Thunder losing. Well, Pryor's one player that would, of course, bolster the Thunder defence. He's not there today. They've just probably lost Cooper for the match. Now the onus is on Lockwood and Smith in defence to really stand tall for the Thunder.
Yeah, absolutely. Chaplin, who came off before with that injury. Yeah, he's another one of those tall key position players in Thunder. They're already missing Justin Bugler, who did his ankle, who's a massive loss as well. And Willie Farrow as well is that tall utility, can play in forward line or back line. He's not in action today with through unavailability. So Thunder, they're a lot of big men down and... As we've just seen, a free kick or a 50-metre penalty, what was that for?
Yeah, look, the free kick was against Pantic for that sliding rule. He slid into the contest, taking out somebody's shins. And then, very unfortunate, Mitch Brewer has been pinged for a 50-metre penalty as he was backing away from the contest. But yet the umpire thought that he wasn't backing away quick enough, and Vassell is waltzed into 15 metres out, and he kicks a much-needed goal for the Thunder. Thanks to a pretty lucky 50-metre penalty against Mitch Brewer. And just to confirm, Josh Chaplin is off with the injury, not Chris Cooper, who I incorrectly said there a couple of minutes ago. So let's just take stock here. The Thunder, 8-1-49. Sorry. Broadbeach Cats, 8-1-49 to the Thunder, 10-4-64. Margin is 15 points. And 26 minutes in to this second quarter. We better get the ink out because Brad Vassell has got his first. Ball back in the middle. Brewer, convincing ruck work there. He goes again. Handball inboard. Found Vassell. And it releases Smith on the wing. A kick towards full forward. Getting back here, Emery in front of Ewing. And now a little dinky kick has found Nathan Quick. Margin's now 15 points. Kick in board, finds Alice. Over the top to Fife. Fife will go to Brewer. Coming in from the side is Vernkum. Did well. Now the Thunder have got numbers. Wanamary puts it in board to Islet. We're approaching half time. Can the Thunder get a late one? Islet's told to play on. Go short over the top to Brown. We're now 27 and a half minutes in second quarter. Brown's kick just over the top of Stewart. Argus has got some work to do.
Geez, that kick almost came off, didn't it? Just needed an extra couple of centimetres to get over the top of the Cats player.
Hasn't Kevy Vernkum got the hair just like Nick Nat Nui? Speaking of Nick Nat, over the top was Vernkum, but it's the Cats streaming away with it. A check side kick in favour of Haley here. And also, that could be a mark. It's paid the mark to Cockatoo. Then he plays on. Handball inboard to Vassell. Out wider, back to Cockatoo. Might have been intended for Islet. Then a kick towards the pocket. Cats couldn't quite mark. In goes Vernkum. Dunn was well tackled. Vernkum goes again. The Cats want the boundary line. They find the boundary line. Over the line and out of bounds. The intensity is still there, Jess. 28 and a half minutes in second quarter.
There's a little bit of flash of brilliance there from Cockatoo. Isn't it good to watch some confidence from a young 16-year-old just to take him on?
Gee whiz. He looks a lot more senior than 16 out in the footy field, that's for sure. He is a big chance to be drafted, Nakia Cockatoo. Keep your eyes and ears out for that name. 40 out from goal for the Thunder.
And just his third game at NEAFL level as well. He's only ever played about 2 or 3 senior games in the NTFL as well, so he's come straight into this level.
There'll be a free kick here, Jess. For a moment there, I thought it might have gone to the Thunder, but I think it's against Cooper on Stewart. That kick towards Hancock. It's a free kick. A free kick here to Thunder. Handball from Brown. Found Islet. He uses Staunton. Staunton all wrapped up, but had time to get it towards Rosier. Back in board to Brown. And now out to Islet. The Cats are getting back in numbers, approaching half time, but they thread the needle. Beautiful kick. Islet has found, I think, Baden Nelkin.
And they continue to be patient, Thunder. Just when you think they're going to blaze long into the goal square, it's working really well for them today. Just to kind of hold it up around that 50 metre and just try and hit up a little target just inside 50. And yeah, it was great work from Nelkin actually get to the fall of the ball of that one. And let's see if he can kick truly.
He's got two already, and that one is right over the goal umpire's hat. Beautiful finish. So the Cats got the margin back to 9 points. But back-to-back goals for the Thunder as we approach half-time. The margin back out to 21. Nelkin's now got three, including that absolute rip-snorter in the first quarter in the pocket there, that same sort of pocket where he just kicked to... In fact, no, it was the second quarter, wasn't it, Jess? The first goal of that second quarter. And alrighty, ball back in the middle, 11-4-70. Plays 8-1-49, as I said. Margin back out to 21 points.
Got to reply to this, KB. Got to get the next score now.
Have we still got time for another goal? I suppose we have. We're 30 and a half minutes in, second quarter. We had 10 goals kicked in the first quarter, and we've got 9 already kicked here in the second. Nelkin and Dunn have 3, and Ewing has 2 for the Thunder. The Cats in the middle. Can't quite get a clean one out. Rosier. There's still time here for the Thunder, maybe. No, there's not. There's the siren. We've got a player down in the middle. It's a Thunder player. They'll get around him here. He's Matty Rosier there, Jess. And he's not in a good way.
No, I think he's just copped maybe a heavy knock either to the head or... It doesn't look like he appeared to have an injury. I think it just it was just a heavy knock and a tackling contest. I think he'll be all right. He's tough as nails, Matt Rosier. They all are normally from Alice Springs, aren't they? But no, he'll be right. He'll be up and about. But geez, look, it was an interesting quarter. It was the first one that sides just went goal for goal. And it was pretty free flowing. In this one, Thunder obviously started with a bang and kicked the first four. And Broadbeach did really well to hit back. But geez, that 50 metre penalty really hurt. And then Islet that. Great leadership and poise just to kind of spot up Nelkin there. And Nelkin normally doesn't miss. He's got superb skills. So Cats will be probably unhappy with just that last minute or two of that quarter because they did so well to get themselves back into the contest. It's not over by a long shot, but geez, Thunder will go into this really happy they've come here after a disappointing loss at home against Morningside. And they'll be keen to make a statement here today, and they're doing very well so far to do that right now.
And we'll keep an eye on Josh Chaplin as well. Some injury concerns for the Thunder, Jess.
Yeah, absolutely. Came off in that second quarter. He's still on the bench now. He's got ice on his ankle. Both boots are off. Not quite sure he's going to come back on. But another tall down for Thunder. So it'll be interesting to see if that plays a role in the second half, considering Broadbeach are getting great service out of their talls today.
Halftime here at H&A Oval in Broadbeach. Hope you're enjoying the action on Thunder Vision. We'll be back shortly as the Thunder lead by 21 points at halftime.
Your team.
Our time.
sign up as an NT Thunder member for 2013 and help support your territory team. Family and corporate memberships are available. For full membership package details, visit the Thunder website.
Oh,
Welcome back to H&A Oval as we start the third quarter here, bathed in sunshine at Broadbeach, just at the back of Surfers Paradise. In beautiful conditions. 21 points to margin for the Thunder as we start this second half. The Thunder will kick to the right of screen, the Cats to the left. Matt Ridley here joined with Jess Webster. Can the Cats get themselves back in it? Well, they're going in the right direction early. Hancock and Cockatoo. Some hands on the footy there. The umpire says I'll have it. Umpire Cronk it is. So 8-1-48. Plays 11-4-70. Margin 21. The Thunder lead. Brennan in the ruck. Vernon, but a quick kick came from Greeley. Tumbling ball. That was a Falcon there on Emery. Rioli was well tackled. Brewer's got some room to move. Handball around the corner to Seal. Tumbling ball. It'll go over the line and out of bounds. So the Cats really want that first goal of this third quarter, Jess Webster.
Yeah, because they really need to make the move. You feel Josh Chaplin came off late in that second quarter for Thunder with an ankle injury. He won't be back on today. So they're a man down and a key position player down as well.
Off the ground. Lux of fortune. Josh Searle it is. Yes, he's got his second. It was a bit of a suspect throw-in from the boundary umpire, but luck is a fortune in the way it bounced truly for the Cats. So that is the goal they needed. The first one of this third quarter, folks. Thanks for watching Thunder Vision. Hope you're enjoying it. Margin is back to 15 points. So at quarter time, the margin was 3. The Thunder led 21 points at halftime with that first goal. The first score of this third quarter, margin is 15.
And as you mentioned before that goal with Chaplin coming off of Thunder, it means they're a tall down. They didn't come into the game with a lot of tools anyway. Bugler, of course, has that ankle injury. Pryor still is yet to come back at the side, and Farrah as well was unavailable. So with Broadbeach getting a lot of good service with their tools today, you feel as though that's going to be how they're going to win this game.
Rioli. Got some room to move in the middle there. Kicks towards Ewing. Oh, that was a good lead and a good kick. Crawford came out, tried to ride the bump. Nalkin was legged, but play on. Crawford handball towards Greeley. That was clever. Good work. Jake Greeley showed a clean pair of heels and then a kick towards half forward. Wosley Black off hands, paid the mark, and then turned around onto that left boot to Rosier. Out wider. This looked like Brown. Kick towards Ewing. Couldn't mark. Crawford did well. Then a quick kick from the Cats defence. Out of bounds on the full. Margin 15 points. And we are 3 minutes in. Now there's a whistle here. Mark taken. Thought it might have been a free kick down the field. Quick kick. Nice kick. We've seen that a lot, haven't we? That 20 metre kick when they're about 60 out from goal. They haven't bombed it to the teeth of goal. They've been quite clever, the Thunder midfielders, in spotting up. And I think on this occasion, Chris Dunn has marked.
Yeah, absolutely. And I feel like a lot of sides might let those kicks go because they feel like, oh, they're still, you know, one or two away from goal. But because I think they're expecting that to go long into the square, but Thunder aren't. And they're making the most of their opportunities. Obviously, that one was an uncharacteristic miss there from Dunn. But Thunder are just doing it really well when they go forward. I've liked what I've seen today in terms of their patience and their skill execution as well.
Margin 16 now, 11-5. To 9 goals, 1 behind. So straight kicking for the Cats. Keeping them in the contest here. They're at half back. Handball to Pantic. He had to hurry that one. Looks for Greeley. Vassal with the stronger body. Fed off the would-be tackler. Oh, Brown was dispossessed. Good tackle there from the Cats. They're in this. Don't worry about that. Here comes the big fella, Nathan Quick. Kicks it towards Brewer. And Brewer has marked. He's within scoring range. He's got some Cats here in the pocket. 1, 2, 3 Cats. But Brewer, he'll backing himself. 50 metres. 50-metre penalty for the Cats. This will take Brewer all the way to the teeth of goal. The margin will be back to 10 points. The Cats with the first two of this third quarter. And momentum's a funny thing in footy. If you can catch that momentum and run with it for as long as possible, it'll win you more games than you lose.
And geez, we've seen a couple of 50-metre penalties today that have directly resulted in goals. Of course, Brad Vassell's in the last quarter was quite important when Broadbeach had made their move, and that just kind of settled Thunder a little bit. And now this one, Brewer getting his third, is the only multiple goal scorer, or sorry, the second multiple goal scorer after Searle's goal just before. But he's had a pretty good game in the ruck and up forward as well, and needs to keep kicking those ones for Broadbeach to get over the line here today.
Well, he has kicked it that far, it has knocked a koala out of a gum tree. And the football has stayed in the tree. So we have lost a footy here at H&A Oval, right at the back of the goals at the beach end, the left of screen, and the school end to the right of screen. But Mitch Brewer, he's kicked that 60 metres. He was 10 metres out. And so it's actually stuck up in the tree. Have a look at all the kids there. They're trying their best to get it out of the tree. That'll keep them occupied for a few more minutes down there. So we've got another footy back in the middle. Game alive here. Cats have kicked the first two of this third quarter. Margin 10 points. 10-1 to 11-5. In total, that's 21 goals 6. That's a good return.
It's been great footy here today. Like we keep saying, it's beautiful conditions. Fantastic. I am wearing a jacket, but for all those Queenslanders, they love it out there. And the sunshine's not too bad, but beautiful oval here at H&A Oval. It's a great surface and it suits both teams, and we're just seeing a great shootout.
Here go the Cats again, a tumbling ball. Now they're inside 50. A quick kick over the top from Walton. He's got quick from the pocket. He wants Brewer. Can Brewer get there? No. Lockwood in pursuit. So too Smith. Brewer just riding the tackle there. Over the line and out of bounds.
A smart kick from Quick too. It was just out of reach of Buell, but it was on his advantage, and he had to sit there and the strength to get it, but it was just too far out of his reach.
We're 7 minutes in. Third quarter. Margin 10 points. The Thunder still lead. They probably need the next goal here just to stem some momentum as the Cats are coming early in this third quarter. Oh, gee. Brennan was there. Handball came from McKenzie. Now Burton. And then a quick kick, I missed that one, towards Brewer. It's touched off the boot. Emery's there. There's a free kick.
Oh.
It's downfield, is it? It's going to the Cats.
Yeah, slight holding in the marking contest there from Lockwood. But, geez, I felt he was hard done by a little bit. And they're costly free kicks, aren't they, from that far out of goal. You feel like Brewer won't miss this one. And geez, and now it puts the pressure right back on NT Thunder.
The margin got out to 28 points midway through the second quarter. If Mitch Brewer can kick his fourth for the match, his second for the quarter, the margin will be just four. From 25 metres, he kicks. We wait on the goal umpire. It's close. It is a goal. Brewer's got four. And now it's 11 goals apiece. 11-1 plays 11-5. The Cats are back within 4 points here at H&A Oval. Round five, game of the round. Ding-dong battle it is, 8 minutes in third quarter.
11 goals, one, we keep saying it, you keep kicking straight like that, it's going to go a long way to winning games of football, but Broadbeach, they've done so well to get back into this contest. I've been really happy with the start of this third quarter. It's just about sustaining that and keep exposing Thunder with their height. Like Brewer with four goals is an excellent return, and he's causing a lot of headaches all over the ground, so he's going to keep getting maximum use out of their tools.
And here they go again, ball back in the middle. Veve it is doing the ruck work. There's Wheels. Handball came from Scott. Bit of an up and under here for the Cats. Mark taken, mark paid. So we're yet to see a goal for the Thunder in this third quarter. Risky kick, but it paid off. Mark taken, Adam McKenzie. That's another short kick towards the forward 50. But dropping back in the spot there is Nathan Brown. Brown kicks. Templeton did well. Now he's got to get the handball. He does. Pancic just had time to Geary. Now backwards to Wells. Now he just pops it up. It's going to be a one-on-one. Rosier, Wells, big hit. Tough footy in there. Who can win it out? Keep an eye on Rosier because... Well, he got a big hit just before halftime, and I hope he's okay, Matty Rosier.
Yeah, like I keep saying, he's tough as nails. He's already up and about. He just put his head over the footy there and got a bit of a knock, but that won't deter him at all.
Pancek tried to burst his way through. Geary got a cheeky kick out to Jake Greeley, who kicks it towards Brewer again. One-on-one with Lockwood. Of course, the NT defence is under strength at the moment with the injury to Josh Chaplin there in the second term. And now they're under siege. The Cats have kicked the first three of this third quarter. Margin back to 4 points. We've been going 10 minutes. It's a whistle on play. Free kick to the Thunder, deep in defence.
Yeah, Vivi getting the free kick there. I think just a bit of too much of a push out there from Brewer in their marking contest. Thunder, geez, and they coughed it up again here now.
Lucky not to give away the free kick. Emery, Hamble, now Walton. Snap around the corner again. One-on-one, the big fellow Mitch Brewer. He wants to do the roving. He lays it off to Quick. Quick around the corner, tumbles through, minus score. Oh, ho, ho. Do not go anywhere, folks. If you're watching this live on Thunder Vision, 11-2 plays 11-5. The Cats are back within 3 points.
And just as though, just what Thunder did in that second quarter, they kicked the first four goals, and Broadbeach should come out in this quarter and done the exact same thing. It's just been a great game of ebbs and flows, and two sides have traded blows, and it's just been a wonderful contest so far. And geez, it'll be a great victory, I think, for either side to get over the line here today. They'll take a lot of confidence out of it.
Vassell from the back pocket, trying to get some space here for Nelken. He might run onto a two here, Baden. He's got some help. Wills, Wanamiri, Dunn. Now they're out. Wosley Black running into trouble. Can he get a clean possession away? He might be able to do it now. Close to the boundary line. A kick towards full forward. Yes, mark taken here for the Thunder. 15 out from goal. And I think Lockie Argus has taken the mark.
He sure has. And geez, Aaron Wosley Black, like Nakia Cockatoo before him, showed a bit of confidence at 18-year-old in just his fourth game for the club, fourth or fifth game for the club this year as well. But another one of Thunder's bright young stars, and run all the way from the back line there to create that opportunity. But great mark out in front by Lockie Argus. He's a good kick for goal, and he won't make a mistake here.
Kick six in the reserves just a couple of weeks ago. Argus, can he kick the most important one for the Thunder today to stop the Cats' momentum midway through this third quarter? He can. He's got it. He's got his first. Lockie Argus with the first goal for the Thunder in this third quarter. So just as the Cats were coming, a little bit of breathing space yet again for the Thunder. 12-5-77 to, what's that now? 11-2-68. Thank you. The young kids over there. Margin now 9 points.
And yeah, it was, again, like I said, a great finish from Lockie Argus. And after five lead changes in the first quarter, we haven't had another one since. So Thunder just managed to keep their noses in front. The longer this game goes on, it just becomes so vital after they lost Chaplin in the last quarter and they're down a few big men. It'll be a good victory for them, I think, to come away, considering they're so undersized and under strength today.
So ball back in the middle. It's come back a little bit waterlogged. Hitting the puddle there. Lockie Argus kicked it into the school. But Brewer now back in the ruck for the Cats. Hamble came out there. Islet, a hurried footy. That's Stewart. He reads the play very well for the Cats in defence. Hamble came out. Now they're under pressure. Rosier was stripped of it by Nick Alice. This is Searle. Close to the boundary line. In fact, it is. It was over the line before he kicked it, Jess, so we'll have a throw in. We're in attack here for the Thunder. 9 points a margin. 14 minutes gone, second quarter. Fantastic game of footy here. Round 9, match of the round. Ball comes in. Neil Veve with the front spot. Brewer was all wrapped up. Greeley got a cheeky handball, so too Walton, and now Fife. And up and under. They've got to go for it. Wolseley Black and Hancock. Hancock had the front spot. Wolseley Black was dispossessed. Ben Hancock goes again. Walton by hand in board. Now they try and team up. They did it well. Fife towards full forward. A tumbling ball. A mark taken. The Cats will have a shot on goal to get it back to a 3-point lead.
And yet another contested mark inside the Broadbeach forward 50. It really has been their strength today. And you can see the size difference there against young Benny Rioli. And they're really causing some headaches for Thunder in that forward line. When they get it in quick and long like that, they just look so dangerous.
Taylor Haley from 45 starts to the right, but it bends back nicely. He's got it. I'd like to see a bit more celebration by the Cats there. Not quite what I want to see here as we're midway through the third quarter. They've got themselves back in it. You've got to get up and about, boys. You've got to get the high fives and the slap on the backside. Margin back to 3. 12-2 plays 12-5. What a game we've got, Jess. We are 15 minutes in second quarter.
It's just fantastic, isn't it? I mean, we've only had 7 behinds and 24 goals. It's just...
Oh, it's fantastic.
It's great footy, and you'd hate to see a loser come out of this one because we know it's one of those classic...
Could be a draw.
It probably justifies the contest at the moment because, look, it's such an important game for both sides as well. Thunder in the top 5 only on percentage. Broadbeach a game outside the top 5. And a win or lose for either side is going to have a pretty big result on the ladder. So as we enter the halfway stages of the year, you feel as though this could be a very pivotal moment for both the club seasons, you'd think.
So they do it all again in the middle. McKenzie can't quite get it out because Islet's got him all wrapped up. The brother of a bulldog, Cam Islet. VV in the ruck. Islet was there. Pantic came in. Umpire does it again.
Geez, VV is such a good story. It's only during the week that he was named as AFL Northern Territory's new multicultural ambassador. He only played his first full season of Aussie Rules in the last NTFL season and won the Rising Star. He's from Vanuatu, played rugby league all his life in the Territory and then switched over to Aussie Rules. He's got a bright spark and this is his first NEAFL season as well. So he's a role model up there in the Territory and he's doing pretty well with his footy career at the moment too.
They're trying to get him forward here. Really had it and he might be in trouble. No, the umpire says I'll have it. So a little bit of a lull here. 16 and a half minutes in. Third quarter, Brewer. Not to advantage. Kick came from Nathan Brown. Getting back again here is Stewart. Kick over the top to Fife. The Cats trying to get that loose man. Fife inboard. Finds Josh Searle. He's got 2 goals, but he's at the defensive end. Out towards Hancock. Just got rid of his opponent, but play on the call. He goes back inboard. A risky kick. Ryan Pantic has marked. He wants 50. He won't get it. Picks up the footy, then kicks it in the middle. Another risky kick. This time, it might not pay off. Oh, bursting through here. Jake Greeley takes a bounce, runs to 50, goes for goal. It's a free kick. A free kick to the Cats. This will put them in front for the first time since the 27-minute mark of the first quarter.
And Matty Rosier, he's in a lot of trouble here. He just landed awkwardly in that last marking contest. They're calling for the stretcher. He's holding his knee. And, geez, that is a huge blow for NT Thunder. He's played a great game here today, but he's so important to their midfield group, and he is in a lot of trouble, a lot of trouble.
We'll go there now, Jess. So Matt Rosier in the middle of the ground. They've called for the stretcher here. So we've got time just to talk this through. So Rosier, he got a massive knock just before halftime. Another knock early in the third quarter, and now he's got this leg injury, and the stretcher's come out. Gee, I hope he's okay. The boy from Alice Springs, they breed them tough in the Alice. And Matty Rosier, I hope he's okay.
He's just grimacing in pain at the moment. He's holding his knee, I think it is. But geez, he's in a lot of pain, and he's so important to their side. And as we just wait here for the stretcher to be brought out in the ground for Matthew Rosier, the Centralian leader. Huge blow for NT Thunder. They've also lost just Josh Chaplin to an ankle injury last quarter. So now they're going to be 2 men down for the rest of the game.
We need to remember too, Callan Geary was the recipient of the free kick on the teeth of goal there. So he'll have a shot on goal. Right on a very acute angle. Of course, he marked it right on the teeth of goal, so he'll be put on the most acutest angle you can be on when shooting at goal. But Jess, I think that's very important, that comment you made, because Josh Chaplin is that's the end of his game, or is it? Yes, that's the end of his game, and now Matty Rosier will be stretched off, and we can only assume that's the end of his game as well. So, injuries.
It seemed pretty innocuous. It doesn't look like a hyperextension or a twisted ankle or anything. I saw him when he landed after he tried to spoil that ball, but he went to ground straight away and just clutched his knee. So, just doesn't look good. It's a huge blow, and he, of course, came runner-up in the Grogan medal last year and had his breakout year. He's only 22 years of age, and is, he represents the future of NT Thunder, and it's just, you just don't like to see that to somebody who really sets the tone for the side in the middle of the ground. He's such a good on-baller. He wins the hard ball, and we've seen today a couple of knocks already. It's just, that's just the way he plays his footy, puts his head over it. He's so courageous. Unfortunately, it's undoing, I think, today, but...
As we speak, Jess, you might be able to hear it in the effects mic at home there. The breeze is picking up. It's getting a little bit chilly up here in the commentary box.
I'm struggling a little bit.
And I think the breeze is now going to the right of screen, which means the... I mean, what are we? We're now 21 minutes into this quarter, but I dare say we've lost 3 or 4 minutes due to this injury. But I dare say that the... Okay, so what we might do here, so we're just hearing Daniel Archer on the bench here, the coach of the Thunder. They will not be able to carry Matt Rosier off on the stretcher. It is a compound fracture of the leg. Okay, now don't quote me, I'm not a doctor, but those involved, I'm sure, are in the know with what goes on. So what's happening is they cannot stretcher him off. They will have to wait for an ambulance. So amazing scenes, just as the Thunder were getting back into the contest and now a shot on goal to get back in front. We will take a break. In fact, we will. We might take a quick break here on Thunder Vision. Don't go anywhere, folks. We do wish Matty Rosier the best out there in the middle. But as we stand, we're midway through the third quarter. Both sides will go back into a huddle. We await the delivery of an ambulance to take Matty Rosier to hospital. We believe he's got a compound fracture of the leg. The Thunder by 3 points. We'll be back shortly here on Thunder Vision.
Your team.
Our time.
Sign up as an NT Thunder member for 2013 and help support your territory team. Family and corporate memberships are available. For full membership package details, visit the Thunder website.
So welcome back to H&A Oval here, back on the live stream. Matt Ridley joined with Jess Webster. We've had a 25 to 30 minute delay as we've seen the ambulance officers come in on the ground and attend to Matthew Rosier, who we believe may have a compound fracture of the leg. And so the unfortunate for the young rover for the NT Thunder. The momentum was with the Cats before that terrible injury, and we just await for the ambulance to get themselves ready, and the officers in there attending to Matthew, and we'll begin the game. But as we pause the live streaming, Jess, both sides went to a bit of a huddle, and then they tried to keep warm and stretches and a few drills, etc. Because as we stand, the match really is in the balance.
Absolutely, and Broadbeach have a mark and a shot on goal in their forward 50 at the moment. Thunder up by 3 points, but it looks like Broadbeach will hit the front for the first time since the first quarter. And Thunder really under the pump now. They lost Josh Chaplin in the last quarter to an ankle injury. He's gone for the game, which leaves them a tall down in defence. We know how well Broadbeach's tools are playing today. And then Matt Rosie, who really does set the barometer for the Thunder's midfield group, runner-up in the Grogan medal last year. He's a Centralian leader from Alice Springs, tough as nails, and he's so courageous. And they're really going to miss that, you feel like, in the latter stages of this game. It'll be a mighty victory, I think, if Thunder can come back with two down on the bench and having such two key important players out as well. They're going to need to find every single ounce of energy and all that to get over the Cats here today.
We'll have to give both sides and coaches and staff at the club credit for the way they've dealt with this injury as well. They got onto it very quickly. The stretcher was called very quickly, but unfortunately, because of the injury, they didn't want to move him, and the game was stopped. And both coaches agreed that the fellas could have the footballs on the oval and continue to keep warm and basically keep themselves in the best condition possible for the game, as the shadows are lengthening here at H&A Oval in Broadbeach, just at the back of Surface Paradise. Beautiful conditions for the players, and we've had that 35-minute delay. This quarter, incidentally, if you are watching it around Australia or around the world, this quarter started at 2:26 p.m. It's now 3:13, so effectively, my maths is correct, 47 minutes for the quarter thus far. Is that right, Jess? Yeah. 40.
My math's terrible. I'm not going to fight you on that good, one. Whatever you say is correct.
So 48 minutes into the quarter, basically, but the injury occurred, I believe, at the 16-17 minute mark of the quarter. But you might be better at getting that one for me. But
well, I had 18, but again.
Okay. No, that's good. No, I need to know that. So injury at 2:44 p.m. So spot on, half an hour break, and the ambulance, as we can see there now, is exiting the field, and all players and umpires and everyone around the ground will put their hands together as an appreciation for Matthew, and we do hope he's okay, and I'm sure we'll see him back on the footy field very quickly. But the teams are ready to go, 36 players out on the field, and as Jess said, the Thunder have lost two players through to injury, Chaplin and now Rosier. Jess, who are you tipping from here?
Look, I'll have to go with the Cats. I mean, they've got a full bench. You feel like Thunder, when they travel, you know, their second half isn't as strong, and I do think Broadbeach will get over the line in this one. In saying that, Thunder, look, they have plenty to play for today. Patrick Heenan was a late withdrawal as well, with the tragically a close family member of his passed away on his home of Goulburn Island off the coast of the Territory. So, you know, in Thunder, they are such a close-knit group that they really do like to honour one another through football with their performances. So, and we've seen that in the first half. It's some of the best football I've seen them play all season. And you just feel like now that they'll definitely want to get a win for Rosie, but it's going to be a mighty effort, you'd think.
All righty, so we're back underway. 30-minute break there, and it's Callum Geary in the pocket. He's on an acute angle. His side trails by 3 points. And we'll begin play now, effectively 18 minutes into the quarter. But we did have that lengthy break. So here comes Geary from the pocket. Will he use the banana, or will he kick straight through with it? He plays on, uses a banana, and he's kicked the goal. The Cats are happy. And there it is. So the goal has been kicked. Geary, for the first time since the 27-minute mark of the first quarter, the Cats are back in front, and there's some feeling out there between the players. Bit of push and shove. Chris Smith throwing his body around. And there you have it. So Geary has his first. And after that long delay, folks, we're back in action. The Cats are back in front, 13-2. That'll be 80 to 12-5-77. Margin 3 points.
And you can tell just how important that goal was there to the Cats. They really were up and about. A huge celebration there. They're back in front. They know now is the time for them to really stretch their legs in the latter part of this third quarter and set themselves up for the last.
No ball back in the middle. Vernkham couldn't quite get the handball out, so the Cats will win it. A kick towards half forward. Smith one-on-one. Sockers it. Gets it towards the boundary line, and then he looks for a shepherd as Staunton gets there first. And off a step, heads in the Vernkham correct direction. He marks, hasn't quite got enough on the kick, so Fife got back in front of Wanamere, coughed up the handball to Motlop. Good tackle, good footy. This has got some feeling in it now. Kick, short one. Pantic over the top. And now the Cats through Wells. Ben Wells goes towards Emery. They need more from him. Pretty quiet first half, Kieran Emery. Has hot got, he kicked the goal in the first quarter, but since then has been unsighted towards the big Mitch Brewer at the back. It'll be a free kick. It's going to the Cats. The Cats with a free kick against Lockwood. I think that's a little bit unlucky. I think they're both going for the ball. A little bit of body contact's okay, but on that occasion the umpire thought, well, wasn't within the 5 metre radius.
Yeah, look, I think very harsh done by the by Lockwood. I don't think it kind of really impacted or advantaged any player that kind. It was just normal body contact. I felt, didn't think it was anything over the top. And Jesus, it really hurt Thunder if Buell can get his fifth.
What a quarter for Mitch Brewer. He's got two for the quarter. As Jess said, can he have number five? Mitch Brewer comes in and the Cats extend their lead. They've got 6-1 in this third quarter. All the momentum continues going the Cats' way. Brewer's got five.
Jeez, it's going to turn into danger signs very quickly for Thunder if they don't peg one back here and just give themselves some confidence. And they really need to win this next in a clearance. As we mentioned, I think, during the second quarter, how Broadbeach were desperate for a goal. Thunder really, really need one here at the moment.
This is a big game for both sides, as you've been saying, all game, Jess.
Yeah, absolutely, with Aspley and Gold Coast looking like they're comfortable winners in their respective matches. This afternoon, that if Thunder lose this, they could fall outside the top five, and depending on percentage, Broadbeach might find themselves inside the top five.
Good work there by Pantic to smother the Motlop kick, and then he's won himself a free kick. So smart football, and a talented one at that. Short kick finds Nick Scott. Scott pumps it 50 metres towards that 50 metre arc. Dropping back here is Stewart. No one standing the mark. So from 55 he goes long. The Thunder have the numbers. Mitch Brewer has the height. Couldn't quite mark. Going through there, Searle. Couldn't quite get it out. Emery's there. He's all wrapped up by 3, 4, 5 NT Thunder defenders. And we'll have another bounce down. 15 out from the Cats' goal. Margin 9 points.
It's amazing how things can change. We were saying this about this point of the last quarter. Our Thunder just looked like they were absolutely on fire. Confidence up and about. But now the Cats, they're all over this game and they can really sniff a win here.
Cooper won the free kick. And the old 1-2 was Smith. But it's not working out for them deep in defence. Good work here. Might be Cockatoo.
It's great work from the 16-year-old.
Beautifully weighted and found Staunton, Vassell, and then Cockatoo's run for him from the, he was 15 out from his own goal.
Over
and now
back.
Islet towards Ewing, one hand, couldn't quite catch it. And now, not Stevenson, Templeton got it to Stevenson. And now to Searle. Now they're a chance of getting here, the Cats. Can they extend this lead? At one stage, they trailed by 28. Burton, Emery. Now the handball, inboard, Greeley. Nobody can trap it here. Burton was caught high. Free kick to the Cats, 70 out from goal. Lays it off, handball to Pantic. Goes long, Mitch Brewer says mark this. Lockwood with the front spot, defends it towards the boundary line. He might be happy to see it over. He elects to keep it in, he's got some time. Oh, they need some help out there. Cockatoo, handball, Cooper, handball, to Vassal. The intensity's beefed up again here, Jess.
Yeah, except for that kick just went out of bounds on the Fuller. You can tell Thunder are just under a heap of pressure at the moment, and Broadbeach are doing really well. They know that their time to move is now, and they're doing everything right at the moment.
This is Stewart. Just sort of pops it up. Cooper's at the back for the Thunder. Handball over the top. Argus kicks it on that left boot. In fact, he's out of bounds. He was already out before he kicked it. So we'll have a throw in. It might have been Worsley Black. We'll have a throw in. 14-2 plays 12-5. Broadbeach lead here by 9 points.
You feel like, what can Thunder do at the moment? They need to nullify the effect the Brewers having on the match for sure. And you just want to think, what can Coach Daniel Archer pull out here to swing the match back in their favour?
So we've got a throw in. Attacking side of halfway for the Cats. Brennan in the ruck. Greeley, fantastic quarter of footy here. Greeley, inside 50 mark, taken by Hancock. Benjamin Hancock took the mark. Get back there, Ben. Have a shot on goal. He's going to do that, Jess, from 55. In he comes. Hancock from 52, close to the man on the mark. He likes it. What does the goal umpire say? Just fading across the face of goal. And just the minor score. But the lead extends. 10 points. 10 points the lead here. We're into time on third quarter.
Tommy, push up a bit. He's run over the square. I thought he was going to do that. The umpire called play on, but even though you're in the square, you still have to kick it to yourself before you can run outside the square. But Chris Smith has just waltzed over the square, and we'll have a ball up.
So tense times here. Lockwood, and it could be a free kick play on.
Lucky.
And it's eventually rushed through, minus score. But you're right, Jess. Even though the umpire says play on, you still have to do that little kick to yourself to restart the play, basically, because you're inside that 10-metre allowance. Staunton, out of the defensive 50. Not much to kick to. Crawford, a handball. Brennan, now to Stewart. And his kick will come out towards Quick. He was run down. Good tackling here. So the Thunder trying to muscle their way back into this. Crawford it was again. Stewart, Geary. Gee, that was a clever little tap. Oh, what a Mary. Absolutely cleaned up Stewart with a rib-tickling hip and shoulder.
I think Argus copped a little bit of it as well. He was down as well. What a Mary taking out everyone in his sights.
That was a good old-fashioned hip and shoulder.
We need to see that from Thunder. We need to see someone lift their side. Their backs are against the wall at the moment. They need to find something extra.
Who can win this one? Scott, he's all wrapped up, so the umpire says I'll have it. So 11 points now the margin, 14-4, plays 12-5. So the Broadbeach Cats lead by 11 points. And we're just ticking into 1 hour into this third quarter. Of course, we had a 32-minute break. So effectively, if you're doing the numbers, this quarter now is gone for 28 minutes. Stewart, handball. Now the kick towards centre wing has sailed out of bounds on the full here, Jess.
And Thunder really, I think, just needed to slow it down, just really keep possession of the football. A couple of times they've just kicked it long, and Broadbeach just have so many numbers back. So you just need to settle things down a little bit and get back to that earlier play where they were really patient heading forward and using their skills and finding targets.
Good running there by Julian Lockwood, who got it over to Nelken. And now the short kick towards forward 50, off hands. Taylor Haley's there, so too Walton. Getting in and under there, looked like Vassal. And the umpire says mine, 11 points to the margin. Cats are still in front.
You really need to see something from, we mentioned it pre-game, Wanamiri and Nelken. Those are the kinds of players that can really spark Thunder, you feel.
Ball goes up, Brennan. Neil VV. Greeley again, another clearance. Out towards McKenzie. Now Greeley kept running, great work. Then he bounced it, like basketball style, to get it to Haley. Now to Emery, just not quite getting his hands on the footy there, Kieran Emery. So we'll have a throw in. We're approaching three-quarter time here, Jess. Almost three-quarter time. Boundary throw in here. Brennan and VV. Rioli tries to run away with it. The Cats without the talk there. Almost lost it. The footy's there to be won. Approaching three-quarter time. Who can get that last score? A little bit of momentum going into the final quarter. Nothing doing. Let's do it again. Throw it up. Neil VV got up high. Free kick here, Jess. It's going to the Cats. So, and now no, 50 metres. Oh, no. Dean Staunton was doing his best in getting the ball back to the Cats there. I think it might be Brennan.
Because it didn't go directly to him. It was 50-metre penalty. It's really, it's all falling apart for Thunder at the moment. Ever since we restarted play, it'll be the third consecutive goal. And it's just really hard to see for them coming back from here.
So it's unfortunate. This could be the second goal from 50-metre penalty for the quarter for the Cats. Yes, it is. Brennan has got his second goal of the match. And now the Cats it is that kick away here. 17 points now the margin. 15-4, 94 to 12-5, 77. At one stage there, the Thunder led by 28 points midway through the second quarter. Now they're staring down the barrel of a 17-point deficit.
We just saw that the Cats came out in this third quarter, and just like what Thunder did in the second when they kicked four goals straight, Broadbeach started the quarter really well with three straight goals, and they just kept fighting, and I think it's just... a testament to the spirit of the club at the moment, the way they fought back in this match.
Thunder are trying to go forward here. We're approaching three-quarter time. Rioli and Stevenson, the race is on. Rioli wins out and creates some good meterage. Gets it towards the forward 50. But Nick Ellis sees it over the line and out of bounds. So we'll have a throw in.
I think they've done really well in forcing Thunder. It has been part of them as well, is chipping it around that 50-metre line. But the fact that Ewing, I think, hasn't been in the game, it's really taken a lot away from Thunder as well. They were forced to change up their game today through the players they had out there, but also with Broadbeach and how good defensively they are and with their tools as well. So it's not the style of play that Thunder are used to playing, and you just look at it now and go, well, what can they muster up now?
Someone needs to stand up. They need a bit of magic. Who can provide that magic for the Thunder? Can it be an Aussie Wanamary special or some Nelken magic, a cockatoo run from half back? What can they muster up, the Thunder? But full credit to the Cats here in this third quarter. They're throwing their body on the line. Plenty of smothers and shepherds and one percenters. That's what we want to see. Brewer, only as far as Staunton. Now to Fife. He's a bit of a stalwart, isn't he, Matty Fife, for the Cats? Wesley Black. Don't argue. Get it out of trouble. Oh, good courage shown. Ben Wells dropping back into the pack. And he has marked a kick towards the middle. Hancock. Oh, lucky to get a free kick there. I thought Brown had a fair bit of the footy. Hancock told to play on, so he just pops it up. Staunton dropping back. He's taken the mark. Staunton goes short. Another risky kick. So both sides rolling the dice a little bit here as we approach three-quarter time. Good work there by Wills to provide a shepherd for Nelken. A tumbling ball towards the forward 50. That's Brown. Handball. Snap around the corner from Rioli. Ewing couldn't quite mark. Good defence again. I think this is Stevenson out of defence. And now the tap came from Burton. Cats trying to get out of trouble, trying to get the ball down towards the forward zone.
Jeez, I felt it was a chance gone begging there for Thunder. Rioli had a lot of space, just didn't get enough purchase on the kick, but Ewing at drop mark in the goal square, it doesn't normally happen. But jeez, you think if Thunder can get a goal just before three-quarter time, it would really help them with their confidence, but you got to take your chances.
Only seconds remaining. I can see the timekeeper's got the finger on the horn. He's about to blow it. Pantic got the kick towards Hancock. Is there still time for the Cats before three-quarter time? Kick on its way. The siren has to be close. Brennan, Geary over the top, but it's chopped off by Rioli. That's Benny Rioli over the top to Islet. Seconds ticking away before three-quarter time. Wills overrunning it, and there it is. The siren goes for three-quarter time. That quarter, incidentally, folks, went for 65 minutes. But we did have a lengthy delay for Matthew Rozier injury where the ambulance came out. And the Cats had the momentum at that stage, the 18-minute mark of that quarter. They had the momentum, and they continued to do so. What a quarter by the Cats. 7-1 has set up this 17-point lead. Quickly through the goal kickers, Nelken, Dunn have 3 for the Territory. Ewing has 2 and 1 each to Cockatoo, Vassal, Argus and Brown. While for the home side, Mitch Brewer with 3 goals in that third quarter. He's got 5, 2 each to Brennan and Searle. Singles to Geary, Hancock, Emery, Haley, Pantic and McKenzie. Quickly to sum it up, 17 points the margin here at three-quarter time is Jess Webster.
Yeah, you don't think Thunder could be hit any more harder than they have after losing Chaplin in the second quarter and Matty Rosie's injury. You could tell when play was restarted, they just didn't have many ball winners around the contest, and yet it just goes to show how important Rosie is at the bottom of the packs. He's done very well so far today, and geez, it's not over. It's not beyond Thunder. They're only, you know, 3 goals away from the lead, so it's definitely not beyond them. But they really need to work extremely hard defensively, I think, and they just need to take their chances in attack. So, like I said, if they can come away with a win, it's going to be one of the best wins I think they've ever had. But geez, you have to think the Cats have all the momentum and all the fitness and whatnot to carry on with this one.
That's right, Jess. The Thunder are getting tired, but can a little bit of magic spark them up? You'll see all of the final quarter action after this break. You're watching Thunder Vision. It's three-quarter time. It's the Cats by 17 points.
Your team.
Our time.
Sign up as an NT Thunder member for 2013 and help support your territory team. Family and corporate memberships are available. For full membership package details, visit the Thunder website.
I'm back to H&A Oval as we begin the final quarter here, and it was a 7-goal-to-1 third quarter for the Broadbeach Cats to set up this 17-point lead. At one stage, the Thunder led by 28 points midway through the second quarter, but the Cats continue to muscle their way forward here as we approach the boundary line. Yes, thank you. So over the line and out of bounds, 17 points is the margin. Matt Ridley here with Jess Webster. Jess, well, the Thunder need a little bit of magic, but some say they're getting a bit tired with some unfortunate injuries to some key players.
Yeah, absolutely. In the second quarter, Josh Chaplin did his ankle. He hasn't come back on. And then, of course, that terrible compound fracture to Matt Rozier. Well, we think it's a compound fracture last quarter, which just took so much out of the midfield. He'd done so well in the first three quarters, but interestingly, Broadbeach, you're in the box seat for their fourth consecutive win over NT Thunder, which is unrivaled. Nobody has that kind of record against Thunder since they entered the competition. So, bit of a bogey side.
Maybe they're a chance here. Rioli got it to Wolseley Black, and he's got the running Nalkin here. 40 out from goal. He marks. He plays on. He goes for home. That's the start the Thunder needed. Coach Daniel Archer's on his feet, urging his boys on.
Geez, it was brilliant, wasn't it? You just saw Rioli over the back there on the wing, and then of course Wesley Black just had that great vision to see Nalkin running. And geez, when Nalkin's in that position, the pocket rocket from Hermansburg, the nail gun they like to call him, he's so dangerous in that part of the ground. And geez, four goals from him today, and we called it pre-game. I wanted to see more from Nalkin. I wanted to see more from people like Wanamiri and Nalkin. They're just the kind of players that really spark Thunder, and let's see if they can carry it on from here on in. But a brilliant goal, wonderful way to start the quarter, and this game is not over.
Margin back to 11 points, 15-4, 94 the Cats. And the Thunder now with that first goal of the final quarter, the all-important first goal of that last quarter in a tight contest. Thunder, 13-5-83. Margin is 11 points. Nelkin's now got four goals there, Jess.
He's had a very good game. And geez, the start of his NEAFL career, I think he's kicked five goals, three or four, and now he's got four again today. So it's a wonderful story coming from such a remote area of the Northern Territory as well. And I'm really taking his opportunity at this level. And he's a very classy player.
Umpire Cronk gets us back underway. Brennan over the top of Vernkham. Bursting through there, Pancik. Got a handball away just in time. Smith. Handball to Vassal as the shadows lengthen here at Broadbeach. The kick from Vassal found Motlop. They're finishing well here now. Motlop from 60 metres goes to home, goes to Ewing. Ewing is marked in the square. So it'll be back-to-back goals for the Thunder. And all of a sudden, margin back to 5 points. Ewing kicks his first goal of the quarter. He's got three now.
And they're fired up. Thunder all started in the middle. Islet and Vassal, I think, were in there and won that clearance. And Motlop, we mentioned before, he's had an interrupted season with injury and illness. And great initiative here from him just to take him on, go have a bounce, go for a bit of a run, and just long into Ewing. It's his bread and butter, and he did it brilliantly for his third. And, geez, they're fired up, Thunder. They're not going to give this one away too easily.
Ozzy Wanamiri just coming off here early in the third quarter with some cramp in the lower leg. So he'll get some physio work, and he'll be back out there pretty soon. Margin now 5 points. 15-4 plays, 14-5. So the Cats have still got their noses in front. They are kicking with the aid of a slight breeze to the right of screen. Again, Islet wanting the free kick. He'll get the free kick. He milked that one nicely. So Cam Islet in the middle. His players spread for him. He goes to the scoreboard side. Kick over the top has found Vassal.
It's a bit of loose checking there from Broadbeach. They need to be smarter than that.
The kick there came from Brown to Vassal, and Brown runs for him still. Could have been given the free kick for the chop of the arms, but Nalkin whacks it on the boot towards the teeth of goal. Oh, dropping back nicely here is Wells. And he's going to get 50 metres for his trouble as well.
Here's he. Look out. Keep going.
I think it's Ben Wells. Usually wears baggy or shorts, though, Ben. In fact, that's because it's Stewart. Darren Stewart goes out wider towards Burton. Burton looks. They need a goal here. The Thunder have got the first two of the quarter. Out wider towards Taylor Haley. That's a nice mark. Had to extend the body, the posterior. And then he kicks towards full forward. Brewer's one-on-one. At the back is Burton. No mark. And running away with it here is Rioli. Runs his full measure. The handball was off target. Now it was Hancock. Handball from Wolseley Black, a good one. Rioli. Now the Thunder through Dunn. And then Brown. And now back to Dunn. Then a long kick towards sort of half forward. Staunton it was. So too Cooper. But it's the Cats with the poise. Oh, great mark. Going back with the flight of the ball is Islet.
Geez, he's such a good leader, isn't he? Just to go back to that hole and take that mark. And he started all right, got a clearance early and a few early touches in this last quarter. And he's a proud man and he wouldn't want to let this game slip too easily.
This could be Shannon Rioli, short kick. Finds Cooper. You might have to help me out there, Jess. I didn't bring the binoculars today.
Yes, Cooper, you're all right.
Long kick towards the pocket. Oh, standing tall. Yeah, no mark taken there by Brennan. Over the top. Here's a chance for the Thunder. Can they get back in front? Not on this occasion. Running it out of trouble is Alice. Kicks it towards Hancock. But he hasn't got much to kick to. His midfielders are getting tired. He's urging his midfielders to keep running for me. Create an option. And some indecision there. Pops it to a one-on-one. Greeley. What he lacks in height, he'll make up with desperation, but it's the Thunder getting it out. Short kick. Vassell. Came from Cockatoo. Now Vassell towards Ewing. Ewing's on a lead and he marks. 30 out from goal. He's on an acute angle, but he is a left-footer, Jess.
Yeah, and perfectly weighted kick there from Brad Vassell as well. Just puts it to the advantage of Buff Ewing. He loves that kind of stuff. And, geez, what has he got already today? He's got three, one in this quarter already. And, geez, can he be the person to spark NT Thunder?
From the pocket for his fourth goal of the game.
He's got
yes,
it,
yes, he's got it. The Thunder are back in front. Another lead change. They lead by a point. 15-4 plays, 15-5. The Thunder are back in front. What a game we've got here at Broadbeach.
And 7 minutes into the final quarter as well, and it's a great start. The first three goals to Thunder, and they're up and about. And, geez, let's see if they can carry on. It would be a mighty victory to keep saying it. We thought, geez, nah, Broadbeach, they got the legs. Thunder are down to only two on the bench. And but they're giving it absolutely everything at the moment. It's not really the match of the round. It could be match of the year. It's just been a sensational game of football. Everything's happened.
Margin 1 point. The Thunder are back in front. The seventh lead change of the game. Brewer in the ruck now. The Cats can't get it out of there. The Thunder with some strong tackling. Margin just 1 point here. What a game we've had. And just in the second quarter, the Thunder kicked the first four goals. Then in the third quarter, the Cats kicked the first four or five goals. And now in this final quarter, it's again a string of goals for the Thunder. They've kicked the first three of this final quarter. Now there's some players down. Keep an eye on that. The kick came from Pantic.
Looks like it's Baden Nalkin.
Might be Geary or Walton, is it the two?
Yeah, Geary or Walton.
Yeah, two or the three. So the kick towards Wales. Here they go again, the Thunder from centre wing. A long kick. Ewing's on all by himself here. He marks, and then he'll play on. He'll have a shot from 50. This will put them 7 points in front. Darren Ewing, you beauty! Ewing's got three goals in the final quarter, five for the match, and now they're out to a seven-point lead.
As we see, Baden Nalkin is still on his hands and knees in the centre of the ground. I think he got copped a whack to the head. He was holding his head as he was kneeling down, and they're just helping him up. He's going to come off and get looked at. And, geez, because he's been another terrific performer for Thunder this afternoon, and let's hope he isn't lost either. As you mentioned, Thunder already down two players.
Vital injuries to Chaplin and Rosier there. And now Nalkin coming off, so he'll get some attention, and then hopefully he's back out there. So all of a sudden, with four straight goals in this final quarter, the Thunder now lead by 7 points.
Cameron Islett in there again, and 50 metres as well. So now, in the blink of an eye, the momentum has shifted again to NT Thunder. We thought, geez, Broadbeach are going to run away with this. May got a couple of 50s and a couple of goals in succession, but geez, Thunder have hit back, and it's amazing, the game of football, isn't it? The ebbs and flows, the momentum swings, and geez, and these penalties are just so costly, aren't they? Let's see if Islett can bang this one home from 50 metres. It'll take a bit.
They've kicked the first four of the quarter. This could be the first five of the quarter. Islett, he'll kick from 47. May have been a little bit lucky to get the free kick, but the 50 metres was there because of cheekiness for the Cats. And Islett, yes! The Thunder have kicked the first five of the final quarter, reducing a 17-point deficit into a 13-point lead.
And every single NT Thunder player on the ground has just gone to Islett. Even the defenders have run all the way from the goal square. They knew how important that goal was. And Cameron Islett, the inspirational captain, he's such a good leader. And his last quarter has been terrific as well. He's won a couple of clearances, a couple of free kicks, and really stepped up because he knows how much they need him right now. And that goal was just perfect execution. And geez, the first five goals, and here they come, just when you think they're dead and buried.
Game of the year, this one. We've had 32 goals, 9 kicked for the day. Amazing talent by these players out here. The ebbs and flows, as Jess was alluding to, some injuries, an ambulance on the ground. I mean, it's just an amazing game of football. Ball back in the middle. Can the Cats get one here? Because the Thunder have got all the momentum.
Another clearance to Islett.
And he goes forward looking for Cooper. Couldn't quite mark. Stevenson, the second gamer. He wants the boundary line. Rioli, well, he dropped to the knees. Play on the call. Now he'll get a free kick. So everything going the Thunder way here. Play on quickly. Kick towards full forward. Out came Dunn. Couldn't quite mark. Here it is. Staunton around the body. Is this another one? Play on the call. Over the line, out of bounds. Margin 13 points, and we are 13 minutes in final quarter.
You can see Daniel Archer there just in the coach's box, just motioning to Kevin Verncombe on the boundary line, just to settle things, just to make sure they don't blaze away and let the Cats back into this one. Play the game on your terms and just keep that handy lead they've got.
There's still a chance here for another major here, the Thunder. Vassal, it's on its way. It's not hooking back enough. Minor score. Margin now 14 points. We've got to keep an eye on Baden Elkin too on the boundary line. We're yet to see him resurface from the dugout.
I think it's all right. It's just sitting there in front of the bench. Like I said, I think he just copped a knock to the head, but he was okay. He was walking along the boundary line. I think he's fine. I think they just want to just rest him a little bit and maybe make sure he doesn't have concussion.
Now kick on goal from Shannon Rioli, and that's across the face of goal, a minor score.
To see Belkin is just doing a couple of warm-up runs along the boundary. I think he's fine. He'll come back on shortly.
Margin 15 points. 94 plays, 105, I believe. And the kick comes in. The Cats need something special now. Brewer! Mitch Brewer. The ruckman, he's got 5 goals to his name, and he is not stopping. Over the top to Geary. He better hurry, Callan, as he goes long towards half-forward. But it's all the Thunder. Getting back here is Wolseley Black. Onto that left boot. Hugs the boundary line. And mark taken by Neil VV. And he pops it over the top, looking for Cooper. Offhands by Stevenson. Over the line and out of bounds as Baden Elkin comes on. So 15 points the margin here. 15-4, plays 17-7. 5 unanswered goals to no score in this final quarter for the Thunder. The Cats need to stand up here and be counted. And the umpire says, I'll have it.
Good tackle there from VV. And the big man Brewer, you can really see the size difference, can't you? It's what Thunder have been up against all day.
Brewer gets it forward, off hands. Eventually, it's over the line and out of bounds. Keep an eye on that clock there, Jess. 15 minutes in, final quarter. What an amazing game of football. Ball comes in. Brewer and now Verncombe. But it's straight down to Walton, who gets it forward. They need something special, the Cats. Oh, no mark taken there by Hancock. Great work by Lockwood. Popped it over the top. couldn't quite get a teammate. Nelken with a burst of speed. Handball over the top. It's a free kick.
Oh, no.
It's a free kick to the Cats. Well?
Yeah, I think it was for a high fend off, or was it against Vernken for off the play? Or I'm not quite sure, but it was around the time when Nelken fired out that handball to Vassal. But lucky that... benefit of the doubt given the umpire, because Thunder obviously kicked it into their forward line after the free kick. So normally that's 50 metres, but a bit of a let off there. But geez, I'd love to see the replay on that one.
Is that the little tweak of momentum that the Cats need as they go forward? Mark taken. Not much urgency there from Nathan Quick as he took the mark, but he'll go back. I suppose you've got to have every shot on goal possible. If your side lead, trails by 15 points, you've got to make the most of this. This is a game winner right here. This changes the complexity of the game midway through the final quarter. Nathan Quick for his first of the day and the most important for the Cats. And he's shanked it to the right.
Absolute shocker.
Out of bounds on the full.
Thunder need to be smart here. They just don't want to turn the ball over in this part of the ground for sure. You just got to slow things down and just try and hit up a target and slow down the tempo of the game a little bit so they can hold on to that lead and protect it.
34 of the 36 players out there are all in the forward half of the Cats. Cooper tried to burst his way through. Chopped off here by five. He goes towards the true full forward position. Emery! Oh, he almost had it. He had three quarters of it. Calangiri's there. Well, we'll have a ball up, but it's in the right part of the ground for the Cats. 17 minutes in now, final quarter. They have not kicked a goal in this final quarter. They, in fact, have not scored in this final quarter.
It's pretty amazing considering how up and about they were in the latter stages of that third quarter. And you thought, oh, geez, here we go. Broadbeach going to run away with it. But the way that Thunder have come out...
Jess, I'll stop you there. It's a free kick here to the Cats right in front of goal and 50 metres. So right to the teeth of goal. This is a certain goal here to Kieran Emery. No one standing the mark. All clear given. Goodness gracious me, what a game of football this is. Margin back to 9 points.
Didn't even see what the free kick was for. The 50 metres was probably not giving the ball back directly to the Cats player. But, geez, I don't know.
Wow, what a game of football. Five unanswered goals has eventually come to an end here for the Thunder with a, well, you'd probably say fortunate free kick, because we're in the commentary box, we couldn't quite see it. The umpire paid the push out in the marking contest. And then Emery was able to stroll through to an unopened goal. Margin back to 9. Who is going to win this game? 18 minutes in, final quarter. The Thunder go forward. Courage needs to be shown here from... Stevenson and also Templeton. And Templeton it is. And he kicks it long towards half forward. Oh, no free kick given there. Maybe that was a square up. And now we'll have a boundary throw in. Attacking side of halfway here, Jess. 9 points the margin. And we are now 19 minutes in final quarter.
And you feel like neither side doesn't look like they're slowing down or they're getting tired. It's just about whether or not Thunder can keep their skill execution as high as it was in the first half. And if Broadbeach can just take a couple of big contested grabs from their tools. So it's but they're throwing everything at each other and they don't look like tiredness or fitness is going to be an issue here. It's going to be more about skills and contested grabs.
Who makes the least mistakes? Who can hit the most targets from 35, from 50 metres? Who can slot that goal in from 60 in the ruck? Big tap forward. We'll have a boundary throw in yet again. Brennan in the ruck, just gaining some meterage. The Cats basically need two goals. And two unanswered goals.
And the importance of this game on the context of both these club seasons is massive. As we keep saying at Thunder, and only in the top five by percentage, if they lose, they're out of the top five. And Broadbeach, if they win, they could very well be inside the top five. So,
oh, fancy stuff there from Brown to get it to Nelken and to run away from the defensive 50. Now the turnover. Rioli, he's got room to move. He's got Buff Ewing dropping back in the spot. Ewing, couldn't quite mark. And now he can't quite get up in time. Crawford it is to mop up. And he goes to the outer side. Wells the target. Wells is a man. He couldn't mark. And now the kick inboard from Brown. has found Dunn.
Yeah, really smart there. Really smart from Brown. Just to lower his eyes and go for Dunn. He did have Booth Ewing in the goal square that had a couple of metres on his opponent, but he just wanted to make sure of it, and I think it was a very smart kick. And geez, Chris Dunn doesn't miss many set shots on goal, and I'll back him in for this one. And geez, it'd be such an important goal as we enter the time on period of this last quarter. What has just been an absolute thrilling game. I can't believe my eyes sometimes.
He's got three, he comes in, the NT Thunder love it. Celebrations all round for the team in the predominantly yellow here today. They lead by 15 points now, Jess, and Dunn has got four. So Dunn, Nelken, they have four, Ewing's got five. They've got 13 out of the 18 between them. But more importantly, Jess Webster, the Thunder lead by 15 points as we approach the 22-minute mark of the final quarter.
It's just been incredible. I didn't give them a chance at three-quarter time, and how they've responded. And I can't believe it, to be perfectly honest with you. I think they've shown some of the best passages of play of football I've seen from them this season. They've come in here with a lot of players out, and of course a couple of injuries, Chaplin and Rozier as well, down to two on the bench. This is character building stuff for such a new group, for such a young list. These are the kinds of games that you build a new identity and a new culture on.
Yep, they've shown a bit of ticker here today. Can they take the 4 points? It's far from over. Wanamiri, there's Fife, needs to get rid of it, goes back to Alice. That's a nice kick. Walton, handball over the top. Can they get some clean possession? Eventually it finds Brewer. Brewer has marked. Oh, and then he shows a bit of candy, and then he kicks it towards full forward. Emery, can he stand up at the time they need him? Rioli, he's got it on a string, eventually lost it. He gets it back. He might be paid a free kick. Play on the call. Greeley was tackled. Umpire says I'll have it.
Jeez, it's great tackling, isn't it? Great pressure and great intensity shown by Thunders. Jeez, I feel like in the last quarter as well, the defenders you talk about, Aaron Worsley-Black, Nakia Cockatoo, Benny Rioli has shown something. Julian Lockwood, they're battling against much bigger opponents. You feel like they're just holding their own at the moment. They've just got to keep going, keep battling.
They're finding all the answers. There we go. A burrowing kick has found the boundary line. Smack bang centre wing, 15 points the margin. And we're now 23 minutes in, final quarter. Now the Cats need some magic. We saw the Ewing, Dunn and Nelken goals there. And now the Cats need something similar here in the last 10 minutes.
I feel like about seven goals or so kicked in this last quarter. You feel like the quarter probably will only go for maybe about five or six more minutes, you'd think. So not a lot of time left, but definitely time enough for either side to really, for Thunder to seal it or for the Cats to come back for sure.
Thunder inside 50, puts the Cats under some pressure. A good kick from Alice has found Geary. And now it's 50 metres. So 50 metre penalty here. Geary it is that we want to play on quickly as soon as the mark is set. And that's a pretty healthy 50.
It's a 50 as well.
So the Cats, they need a goal here within the next couple of minutes, that's for sure. The kick towards Templeton. He was too worried about Wanamiri in the end. And now Wanamiri wins the footy. Handball to Islet. Now a kick towards Nelken. And that's a pretty good result for the Thunder. Over the line and out of bounds.
Yep, they'll be happy with that. Just got to keep it in their forward half of the ground. Just keep repelling all those attacks that Broadbeach have mustered in their forward half of the ground. They've had their chances in the forward line, you think.
Margin 15 points. I think Wanamiri's done a hamstring. So keep an eye on that. Just to the right of screen. A kick inside 50. Another goal will wrap it up, though. Ewing runs onto it. He's got more pace than Crawford. Ewing! Oh, bouncing through. A thrust through for a minor score. Margin now 16. So 16-4 plays 18-8. 16 points the margin, Jess. 25 minutes in, final quarter.
Yeah, I think Ozzy might just be cramping. He's just come off the bench and they'll have a look at him. Hopefully it's nothing too serious because his effort just before was exactly what they need in this last quarter.
Islet, what a quarter of football. Over the top to Rioli. Now to Staunton. Now for the cream on the cake for the Thunder. Yes, you beauty. Dino Staunton puts it through the middle. And now it's a 22-point lead. And they'll be taking the 4 points home today in what will be a very emotional win for the Thunder.
Oh, absolutely. Look, we already had Patrick Keenan that was out of the game today. The tragic passing of his uncle back home on Goulburn Island. So he was a late withdrawal. And
And the Thunder boys, they are such a tight-knit group and they love to honour one another through football. Football is such an important part of culture up there in the Territory, and they definitely would have had Patrick Keenan on their minds today. And then to see that horrible injury to Matty Rosier in the third quarter, and for them to respond like this for such a new group, and they keep talking about how to start this year they haven't quite found that killer instinct and that spirit of past teams, and you hear a lot of them saying that they do rely on the results of the great players before them and what they've achieved. So it's about forging their new identity. I've heard that catch cry a lot so far this year, and I feel like these are the kinds of games that you look back on and go, that's how we start something new.
Very well said, Jess. 22 points the margin here. I'm pretty sure the Thunder will win this one, but you just never know. We've seen 7-1 for the Cats in the third quarter, and now 7-1 for the Thunder in this final quarter, and they're going forward again. Rioli off the ground. It's in a dangerous spot here. Crawford left his man to win the footy. Then he tries to win a free kick, and he does. What an amazing quarter of footy. What an amazing half of football. The margin was 21 for the Thunder at half time as the risky kick comes in. Stewart needs to get rid of it. He does. Towards Fife. Rioli was there. Over the top. Alice. A little bit of a tumbling ball. Nobody wants to win that one. Dino Staunton does. Takes a bounce. But then his kick was smothered. And, oh, my God. Goodness me. Dean Staunton has absolutely milked a free kick here. Nothing in that whatsoever. But the umpire has been sucked in 100%. But good on you, Dino. That's the sort of nuggety player he is. He kicked the sealer. And can he kick something special from the boundary line? Short. To Rioli. So we're soaking up some time, and they can soak up the sunshine here at Surface Paradise tonight, the fellas, because they're going to win this one. As Jess said, character building, quite an emotional win. Matty Rosier taken to hospital in an ambulance in the third quarter. Shannon Rioli from the pocket, kicks on goal, and he has got it. The Thunder will win this game convincingly in the end, but what a game of football it has been.
I just can't believe it. The fact from both sides, I mean, we've had 36 goals, 12 in total from both sides. It's just been a wonderful expression of modern football. It's been free-flowing. It's been ebbs and flows and some inspiring passages of play. And I just, every time you count the Thunder out, I've done it before when I thought, geez, you know what, I'm just not convinced about them today. They come out and prove me wrong. I think they love doing it. But it's just been a fantastic win. It moves them now to 4-3 after, you know, and especially too, they've lost two games at home at TIO Stadium. And that's just, they've never done that before. And to respond the way that they have, and hopefully this will set them up for bigger and better things this year, because we just haven't quite seen that spark of the grand final sides in the past 2 years so far this season. But they'll take a lot away from this. And don't forget, Broadbeach have won the last three encounters between these two sides. Nobody has a record like that against Thunder. So
free kick here going to the Thunder. Lockwood it is. We're now into the 30th minute of the final quarter. Broadbeach coach Matt Angus will look at this one. He'll replay the tape two or three, maybe even four times during the week, and just what is it? Shake his head, scratch his ears, and think, how on earth did we lose this one? The Thunder had two men off. They were down to 20 men. They were 17 points down at three-quarter time. Broadbeach had all the momentum. They kicked 7-1 in the third quarter. But yet we've seen 8-1 in this final quarter for the Thunder. And at the same time, we can talk about how good this win is for the Thunder. The Broadbeach Cats, this will hurt.
It certainly will. Look, they're a game outside the top five at the moment. We know how difficult it is to actually get a spot inside the top five. There's NEAFL competition, which has just grown enormously, I feel, in the last couple of years. It's particularly even this year. And now it puts them a little further behind the pack. And after that really inspiring win against Thunder in round one up there in Darwin, they've probably not carried on from that win as well as they would have liked. So
got a lot of work to do, the Cats, but geez, they've got a lot of talent in their side. You feel like in the next couple of years they'll really hopefully be able to grow and finally get that final spot I think that they really deserve.
Well, they're trying to get a late goal here. They're deep in attack, the Cats. The Thunder are just trying to soak up some time. Kick to kick and then close to the boundary line. It's probably less than a minute to go, I'd assume, as Islet it is. Takes it out of defence. They have not stopped running. They're down to 20 men because of those injuries, but the Thunder have not stopped. Kick towards full forward. That's been a good contest. Crawford and Ewing. Ewing get the better of it in this quarter when it was time for him to stand up.
Yeah, the first three goals in the first sort of 5 or 10 minutes, and they're all Darren Ewing specials as well. But yeah, you feel like probably hasn't had the best day by his standard, but you know he's still chipped in with five goals, and always mark that down as a win, don't you?
Pantic doing some work there for the Cats. Wolseley Black getting back here for the Thunder. On hands and knees, handball to Islet, just treads a bit of water, waits for an option, and he sees Brown. Brown takes a bounce, then kicks towards the pockets. No mark taken. Motlop it is, I think, down there. Kick came from Fife. Bangs it long. The Cats can probably win this one. Can they get it forward? Emery provides the Shepherd. Brewer with a little push. Play on the call. Can he get another one? Big Mitch. A kick on goal. And it tumbles through for a minor score. So 27 points now the margin. 16-5 to 28. And we're close to full time.
And this win here will move Thunder to within a game of Morningside, who have lost to the Gold Coast Suns reserves as well. So, and Aspley with big winners over Tuggeranong and Gold Coast, huge win over Morningside as well.
We're approaching full time. The Cats, can they get a late one before the siren? 50 out from goal. The kick came in, but partly smothered. Tumbling ball. Only seconds remaining. Listen to the roar from Daniel Archer. Have a look at everyone. They're off the bench. The coaching staff are all down with all the players. Here comes the siren. There it is. What an emotional win for the Thunder. 8-1 in a final quarter. Daniel Archer shaking the hands. Patting the back of everybody involved in this outfit. That was impressive. Backs against the wall, down to 20 men. And they stood up when they needed to. And this, for the Cats, will hurt. Doesn't get any easier next week. They have to travel to the ACT and play Belconnen. They were looking for back-to-back wins for the first time this season. But to lead at three-quarter time by 17 points, Jess, and then to get nailed by 27 points, that will hurt for the rest of the season, I assume.
Absolutely. And look, on the other side, you can just see it's agony and ecstasy, because for NT Thunder to come here and do what they did, coming off a loss to Morningside on their home ground, and then to respond when they were down to 20 players on the bench, for everyone watching back home in the Northern Territory on Tats Thunder Vision, they would just be, I imagine, jumping out of their seats at what they've seen. For the Territory to come here and represent what they have just done, it was just, it'll go down as one of, I think, the more famous victories I think this club has ever had. The backs against the wall, injuries, of the competition, and now that they're still inside the top five with such a new group, and I think they'll be extremely pleased. They have a bye next week as well, so they can regroup before they come back with a huge run against they play Southport and all the AFL reserve sides and Morningside in the space of 7 weeks. So a massive road ahead for NT Thunder, and they'll be extremely pleased to come away with the 4 points, a huge confidence boost and a bit of inspiration to go along with it. So all in all, just a ripper day for Thunder.
Touching on some major goal kickers out there. Ewing kicked three in that final quarter to end up with five. And four to Dunn, four to Nelken in what was an inspiring final quarter. While for the Cats, five to Mitch Brewer and two each to Emery and Searle. We'll wrap it up here at H&A Oval in Broadbeach. What a famous victory for an emotional charge, Daniel Archer and the Northern Territory Thunder. They now have 4 wins and 3 losses and cement themselves in the top five. Courtesy of NT Thunder Vision, Matt Ridley and Jess Webster, we bid you farewell here from Broadbeach.